And his tackle-breaking touchdown run against Michigan push one. For Western Washington's Chris Moore,
it's a camping trip it required, so he's making his trip right now. Anyway, this facility reminds me a little bit of this when Indiana played on 7th Street, because you've got all kinds of activities going on all the time, such as classes and other things.
All right, we'll be back and take a look at this ball game in detail in a moment, but first let's pause for the 60-second timeout. This is a network break.
Thousands of years ago, the Egyptians kept records of transactions carved on tablets of stone. Adding, subtracting, debits, credits, it was all so simple, but not anymore. Appreciation, depreciation, computers, ever-changing tax and business issues. Put a CPA on your team. Today's certified public accountants are masters in the art and science of maximizing the potential of your money and improving profits. Contact a CPA in your area or the Indiana CPA Society. CPAs make a difference.
This is the sound of a car broken down on the side of the road. The driver is thumbing his way to the nearest Napa Auto Parts store. Too bad he didn't think about that sooner. You see, we carry over 125,000 different parts. So if anybody can help him get back on the road fast, it's Napa. Napa, because there are no unimportant parts.
Well, back once again at University Park, Pennsylvania, as Indiana and Penn State are about to do battle here this evening. Max, as you look at Penn State, they have struggled in the Big Ten their first go around, but injuries have played a part in that.
They certainly were an injured ball club when they came into Indiana. On the very first day, they had four different players that had had some kind of injury and had been out for part of the season before they came. I think all of them were well when they got to us, but that has to be a factor as far as their playing. I think probably, Don, you might agree that the biggest problem they have, they just are not very good shooters. Their shooting percentage is really low.
And, of course, it's always an adjustment coming into a new league and figuring out the style of basketball play.
It is different. I think they also have to get used to the officiating, which apparently has caused them some concerns. They aren't quite used to the physical facilities that or physical contact that the Big Ten has.
Well, the Nittany Lion continues to go through its gyrations. I think he just ran into an anthill.
Well, he might have, but it looks as if his camping trip is over now, and he's going to take his stuff and go to the sidelines.
Well, obviously, one thing about Indiana coming into this place tonight, it's their first trip here. The Hoosiers beat Penn State by 48 points in the first meeting. But we all know what happened last year in two ball games where the Hoosiers won by 46 against Minnesota and 41 over Purdue. Those two ball clubs came back and beat Indiana on their home floors.
I'm sure Coach Knight has reminded his basketball team of that a couple of times since that game was played on Saturday night, because that is exactly what happened last year. I think Indiana is probably in the most right position that Penn State could possibly get them, in as much as Indiana, as you said, beat them badly, and then with Michigan coming up on Sunday, you might be peeking ahead if you're not careful.
And of course, the ball game tonight is one of those where if you're not ready to play, anything can happen. And of course, Penn State, as we said earlier, plays quite well in this facility. It's their home ballpark. The students are right on the floor in this near sideline to us. In fact, somebody made mention of the fact that if you have to take the ball out of bounds on the near sideline, the students down there try to pull the hair out of your legs.
That reminds me of the days when I first got into this business over at Illinois when they played at Huff Gym. That's exactly what the fans would do along the sidelines when you took the ball out of bounds.
We'll be back to talk more about this ball game tonight, but first, let's pause for the 60-second break. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
I stopped in a muffler shop the other day to see about their so-called guaranteed muffler service. What I saw was this guy offering me the same muffler he had just put on a 1959 Packard. Come on, not all cars are the same, and neither are their muffler systems. A muffler and exhaust system is an important part of your car's performance. At Jim's Tune-Up Center, their muffler service might cost you a little more, but when you leave, you're going to have a big A muffler designed especially for your car or light truck, and it's going to be warrantied for as long as you own that car. That's Jim's Tune-Up Center in Monticello on First Street under the big smokestack.
Main Street Flora is planning great Valentine's Day specials.
You're listening to Joy 103, an affiliate of the Agra America Network. Listen for the latest Agra news every morning at 6:05 and in the noon hour.
Before we go any further, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
You're listening to Joy 103, where you get a wake-up call every weekday morning at 5 with NBC's First Light and your host, Dirk Van.
Now, once again here at State College, Pennsylvania, Rec Hall is the site of tonight's ball game between Indiana and Penn State. Max, this Indiana ball club played exceptionally well, I thought, under very difficult circumstances with the Chris Street retirement of the number at Iowa on Saturday night. And, of course, all the emotion and inspired play of the Hawkeyes still weren't enough to overcome this Hoosier ball club. And even though the ball game looked like it could get out of hand in the first 10 minutes, where Indiana was down by, I believe it was 10 points at one point, this Hoosier ball club hung in there and did exactly what they had to do. That shows you a great deal of maturity, and that's what you expect from a senior-oriented club.
Well, as you were talking there, the word that kept coming into my mind was maturity, and I think that's exactly right. They are a very mature team. Last year, this ball club would have gotten beat under some similar situations, but this year they've been able to take everything in stride, and certainly that Iowa situation was one that could have gotten out of hand in a hurry.
I think the proof of the pudding on this Indiana ball club is, Max, that they're not shooting the basketball particularly well right now. They've shot under 50% the last three ball games, yet they've won all of those ball games, two of those on the road.
Well, they're playing good defense. That's one thing. While they may not be shooting a high percentage, they're certainly not letting their opponents shoot that high percentage either. The other thing, they aren't turning the ball over much. They only turned it over 12 times against Iowa. And, of course, Iowa, with that aggressive defense, you might think there'd be more turnovers than that.
Bruce Parkhill, the head coach of Penn State, coming out on the floor, and they're shaking hands with the Indiana coaches that are out there right now. We anticipate Robert Knight coming out shortly. I'm not so sure. I had heard that Coach Knight and Coach Parkhill went to dinner last night, but I don't know if that actually came down or not.
I don't know. Coach Knight seemed to be in a pretty good mood tonight as he came down to go to the elevator to have the team meeting.
He's always in a good mood, Max.
Well, okay. But maybe let's put it this way. He was in a little better mood then. Here he comes.
Well, the Hoosiers, of course, let's listen to the reception that Bob will get as he walks in here tonight. It starts before he even gets out to the floor.
Oh, he's got a police escort.
He does have a couple of policemen walking out with he and Clarence Doniger, the athletic director at IU, along with Larry Rink. And as we said, his comment, there's the Nittany Lion that comes over, and he pops the Nittany Lion on the head with his program. But certainly his comments, and look, Knight was not the only guy who had some major difficulty accepting the fact that Penn State was coming into the Big Ten, yet I think he's probably had more attention from the Penn State people than anybody else.
You're right about that. And I tell you, it goes the other way. I was talking with a young man here tonight who's on their golf team. He wasn't that thrilled about being in the Big Ten. He said, gee, my parents used to be able to see me play golf. And he said, now we have to get in an airplane, fly several hundred miles away. They never get to see it. He said, I'm not that thrilled about being in the Big Ten either.
Well, the Hoosiers going after their 10th win of the season. For the first time since 1976, a Big Ten team has gone unbeaten in the first half of the conference campaign. And this Hoosier ball club is the team that's done it. As Knight indicated in the pregame, Max, over the years, Indiana's probably won about 65% of their road games in the Big Ten. No other conference team can come close to that. And I think the reason why is preparation by Bob Knight.
Well, he gets them mentally ready. If anybody's going to be ready for this game, it's going to be a Bob Knight team.
Well, let's look now at the starting lineups for tonight's ball game. First of all, for the Nittany Lions, at guard will be Greg Bartram, a 6'5 sophomore out of Chapmanville, West Virginia. He averages 8.9 points a ball game. And Michael Jennings at 6'4, 180, a junior from Severna Park, Maryland, an 8.4 scoring average. In the middle, John Amici, 6'10, 260, a sophomore from Manchester, England. He also attended Toledo, Ohio in high school and went to Vanderbilt in his first year at college before transferring here to Penn State. He averages 13.9 a game. At the forwards, Deron Hayes. He is 6'6, 220, a senior from Lakeland, Florida, averaging 15.2 points a ball game. And Eric Carr at 6'6", 205. He's a senior out of Columbus, Georgia. He'll start at the other forward. He's a 5'4 score on the campaign. So that's the way the Hoosier or the Penn State Nittany Lions will go tonight. The Hoosiers start Damon Bailey at 6'3", a junior out of Heldonville, Indiana, a 10'6 scoring average, and Greg Graham, a 6'5 senior from Indianapolis, a 13'7 scoring mark. In the middle, Matt Nover, 6'8", 230, a senior out of Chesterton, Indiana, a 10'1 scoring average. And the forwards are Calvert Chaney at 6'6", a senior from Evansville, a 22.3 scoring average. And Alan Henderson, a 6'9 sophomore from Indianapolis, a 13.1 scoring mark. We'll be back for the start of tonight's ballgame right after we pause for the 60-second network timeout.
Hi, this is Willard Scott for True Value. We'd like to wish the Indiana University basketball team, better known as the Hoosiers, a great season. Finding a 7-foot center with talent can be difficult, and the same goes for finding household supplies at a good price. That is, unless you're looking through the Dollar Dazzler circular from True Value, you'll find everything you need at a price you can afford. For personal service and low prices, bring your family to the True Value family of stores.
To defend your soybeans against weeds, you need power. You need control. You need consistency. You need this squadron. Squadron Herbicide for a higher level of soybean weed control. See your Cyanamid AgriCenter dealer. Read and follow label directions.
This broadcast is authorized under rights granted by Indiana University to University Broadcasting Company and the IU Radio Network. Any rebroadcast or other use of the descriptions and accounts of this game without the express written consent of University Broadcasting and the IU Radio Network is prohibited. The officials for tonight's ball game are Gene Mongey, Sam Licklider, and Dan Crispin. We are about set for the tip-off of this ball game. Out of the four come Bartram, Carr, Hayes, Amici, and Jennings for Penn State. The Hoosiers have Calvert Chaney, Henderson, Nover, Bailey, and Graham. Calvert will jump it, and the Hoosiers easily come up with a tip. In backcourt, Bailey goes to Allen Henderson, right wing, in the Calvert easy layup. Indiana gets off to a quick start. Chaney was wide open for that easy bucket inside. Good feed. Here's a fall down by Jennings, struggling with the ball, bounces it out, it comes to Amici. Amici gives it back to Jennings. Jennings on the dribble to the right wing. Pulls up on the wing. Lobs it outside. Almost stolen. Hayes gets it back to Jennings, who fires and gets it. Michael Jennings with a quick first 2 points for Penn State. Back the other way. Greg Graham outside to Damon. Damon turns and clears to Calvert. Chaney back to Bailey. Bailey one dribble back to Chaney. They're playing a zone inside to Nover. Turnaround jump shot off the mark. No, and the rebound batted away by Henderson in a foul call. Allen Henderson gets nailed on the personal. That will be his first of the ball game, and they'll go to the other end, and Penn State will have the basketball. So it's a 2-2 tie. Nittany Lion ball. Michael Jennings again will bring it up the floor. Picked up by Greg Graham. Crosses the timeline of the dribble. Working against the Hoosier man-to-man. The bounce pass inside comes off to Carr. Carr on the baseline works. Double team, throws it up. No, and the rebound comes off to Henderson. Henderson to Graham across the timeline. Greg, top of the key, takes it inside, pulls it out and threw it away. Out of bounds, and it belonged to Penn State. They tried to go outside with a pass, and it got away from them. Bob Knight saying something to official Sam Licklider. Penn State will have a basketball. Down the floor come the Nittany Lions. Across the timeline, this is Michael Jennings. Jennings, backcourt dribble stops, looks for help, bounces it away, comes off the car. Back outside to Bartram for a three, and he got it. Greg Bartram drills the first points of the ball game from the three-point range, and it's a 5-2 contest, Penn State. Again, they go to the zone. Graham to Bailey. Bailey outside to Calvert, back to Damon. Damon fakes, doesn't take the shot, into Henderson, down low, puts it up and scores. Allen Henderson bangs his way home off the backboard with a shot over John Amici. The Hoosiers down by one at 5-4. Graham is picking up three-quarter court against Jennings. He gets it across the timeline. Jennings to the left side of the dribble, down toward the baseline, inside to Bartram, who scores again. Bartram got an easy layup that time as he lost his man, and he's got 5 points. It's a 7-4 contest. Indiana down by three. Bailey bounces to Cheney. Back to Bailey, right side to Graham. Greg with the basketball. To Bailey inside, kicks it out to Calvert. Inside to Henderson, back out to Damon. Again, he fakes, drives left, gives to Cheney. He pulls it back outside to set up the offense. Cheney now goes to Bailey. Damon lobs it into Henderson, and he puts it up. No, the ball batted away, and Penn State comes up with it. Amici got some defensive effort there. Here is Carr inside, and he scores. Eric Carr gets his first two. And Penn State's off to a 9-4 start, leading by five. The Penn State fans are on their feet. Here's Bailey in backcourt. Gives it to Calvert. Cheney outside to Graham. Graham back outside to Bailey, almost threw it away. Bailey came up with it, dribbles it back top of the key. Right side to Cheney on the wing, back to Damon. Now Damon goes to Nover. Nover looks inside, pulls it back out to Graham. Graham down the left wing. Gives it out to Bailey. Now off to Cheney. Cheney gives back to Bailey. Bailey sets it up left to Greg Graham. Graham on the wing. Down to Bailey for a three try, and it's off the rim. No. Rebound inside is pulled out of there by Amici. Here come the Nittany Lions. Jennings on the dribble to the left. Bounces it low to Carr. He kicks it back to Bartram. A three on the way. No good this time, and the rebound comes to Henderson. Henderson brings it back down the floor to Greg Graham. Graham across the timeline to Bailey. Damon in backcourt gives it to Graham. Graham fakes, slides it back top of the key. Now he goes to Nover. He drives left, pulls up and got the shot to fall. A blocking foul. He'll go to the line. Matt Nover on a drive to the hole for his first two, and he will get a chance at a three-point play here. He could put Indiana within two if he connects. 9-6 score with 16:06 on the clock here in the first half.
That zone's very effective right now against Indiana. They're using a 2-3 zone for the most part, and Indiana's shots will come from the outside if they're to get it, not from the corner where they like to shoot them from.
Matt Nover at the line. Eyes the attempt. Fires it up and got it. Nover with his third point of the ball game. The Hoosiers are within two at 9-7. Back down the floor comes Penn State. Across the timeline, backcourt dribble. This is Jennings to the left side, on the move against Graham. Stops, bounces inside the Carr. Carr posts up, jump hooks, no good. Rebound, Allen Henderson again. Off to Damon Bailey. Bailey across the timeline. Takes it left side, stops, and he travels. So the Hoosiers turn it over, and timeout is called. The score, Penn State 9, Indiana 7. 15:45 on the clock, first half of play. Back after the 60-second network timeout.
In the Hoosier State. State Farm is helping Indiana families with the free family insurance checkup. A State Farm agent is there to help you keep your car, home, life, and health insurance up to date, so the coverage you need will be there when you need it, wherever you live, from South Bend to Evansville. Check your phone book. Get your free family insurance checkup now.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Great game for copyright, Bob.
And how about that star player, Bob?
Oh, the Canon NP60-60 copier.
Fires a copy a second.
And the Canon NP60-60 has amazing depth.
Holds a million sheets.
Now, Bob.
Okay, 6,100.
Backed by professional service technicians.
Billions of them.
Bob.
Okay, a lot. And each has 70 years of experience.
Bob.
Well, five's the average.
Copyright. The smart choice.
The Canon NP6060 is just plain amazing.
And it's from copyright. Call them today.
Hey, speaking of years, Bob.
Well, back once again here at State College, Pennsylvania, University Park, Rec Hall, home of the Penn State Nittany Lions, and right now Indiana is down by 2-9-7. For the 20th consecutive year, IU basketball broadcasts are being brought to over a statewide network of radio stations numbering over 50 strong, including WCBK in Martinsville, WTCA in Plymouth, WRCR in Rushville, WFML in Vincennes, and WAXI in Rockville.
And done. We need to tell our people back at WOWO out in Fort Wayne that they've got lots of people out here that listen to them. Our Indiana games we've run into. Indiana shooting 50% right now on 3 of 6. Penn State is 4 of 7, 57%. Henderson's got 3 rebounds already.
And Penn State's got the basketball across the timeline. Michael Jennings to the right side. Stops, gets it inside, threw it away. Deron Hayes, the intended receiver on the pass, it went right through his hands, a bit hard on the pass. And Indiana's got it on the turnover, the first by Penn State. Down the floor comes Greg Graham across the timeline for Indiana. Graham started it to the left side, to the wing, pulls up, brings it back outside, drives it right. Looks inside, turns it back out to Calvert Chaney. He fakes, he drives in low, puts it up and got it. Calvert Chaney all the way to the hoop with his fourth point. 9-9 contest now. 15-11 on the clock. First half. Here's Bartram on the right wing, fakes the three, fires it inside and almost stolen by Henderson, but he lost it out of bounds. So the good defensive effort there, but Penn State maintains possession of the basketball. Deron Hayes will trigger it in. Hayes looks, finally gets it to Jennings. Outside pass to Bartram. Down low on the left wing to Hayes. He fires and got it. Deron Hayes scores a two-pointer on the baseline, and it's 11-9 Penn State. Back across the timeline with the ball comes Greg Graham. Graham starts to move it left on the wing to Damon Bailey, top of the key, right side to Calvert, to Henderson, who fakes, drives in, pulls up, shoots, missed the shot. Blocking foul called on Penn State. Eric Carr will be nailed on that one. That'll be his first foul of the ball game. And Alan Henderson will go to the free throw line. We see a lot of driving by this Hoosier ball club, Max. They are really trying to get the ball down low.
The last time down court, Penn State went into a man-to-man. I'm not quite sure why. They were pretty effective, it seemed to me, with their zone. Indiana wasn't hitting that well.
Henderson fires the free one. It's around and in. Alan Henderson's third point of the ball game. He'll have an opportunity for one more. Out of the game goes Eric Carr, and checking in for the first time is Elton Carter, a 6'7", 235-pound junior out of Detroit, Michigan, a 2-1 scoring average in the season. Henderson's second shot is good, and Alan Henderson now has picked up his fourth point. The Hoosiers have tied it at 11. Across the timeline will come Michael Jennings. He picks up Greg Graham as he does so. Jennings spins in backcourt, gets it to Deron Hayes, left wing. Hayes drives, fires up a 17-footer, got it. Deron Hayes buries one, his fourth of the ball game, and that under some good defensive pressure from Chaney. It's 13-11, Penn State. Here's Greg Graham, left side dribble to the wing. Back out it comes to Bailey, now to Chaney. Calvert fakes the three, drives, gives to Bailey, again to Graham on the left wing. Graham brings it back outside, clears to Calvert. Calvert holds high, top of the key, starts to the right side of the wing, looks inside, gives to Graham. Graham fakes, gives it back to Bailey. Damon now looking to clear it, finally does to Greg Graham, who fakes, drives, looks for help, back to Nover, baseline, Matt holds, gives back to Graham, top of the key to Chaney for a three, try, and he missed it, in and out, and the rebound comes away to Penn State. Down the floor come the Nittany Lions. Deron Hayes, top of the key to Amici on the right wing for a three try. It's no good. Inside rebound taken by Carter. He missed it. Got his own board. Back up. Blocked shot by Nover. Calvert tried to save it. Does to Bailey. Good defensive sequence there. Here's Greg Graham. Fires a 16-footer. Missed it badly. Bailey rebounds no. Henderson inside. Fakes. Puts it up and scores. Alan Henderson's got 6. Indiana ties it at 13. 13-15 on the clock. Here comes Penn State across the timeline. Jennings with the ball. Gives to Bartram. Down low. He fires it. No good. Rebound inside to Nover. Out to Greg Graham. Down the floor to Calvert for an easy slam dunk. Calvert Chaney with a reverse slam. His sixth point of the ball game. And it's 15-13. Indiana with the lead. Chris Reynolds getting set to come in at the next opportunity. Here is Jennings driving it right side. Jennings kicks it out to Bartram. Bartram top of the key. Bounces it left side to Amici. Amici drives on Nover, looks inside, turns around, can't find help, gives it finally to Jennings. Jennings baseline, he lets it fly. He missed it badly. The rebound to Alan Henderson. Up the floor, pass to Greg Graham. Graham on the right side of the circle. Pulls it back out, gets it to Calvert inside by himself, and he lays it up in air. Calvert Chaney for his eighth point of the ball game, and again, the Nittany Lions got beat badly inside. 17-13 IU. A four-point Hoosier lead, their biggest. Now, Here comes Jennings. Left side pass comes to Hayes. He pumps a three. It's got it. Deron Hayes has got seven, and he started out with a great hot hand here tonight. 17-15, the Hoosiers lead it by just two. Apparently, it was not a three. Across the timeline, backcourt's Graham, gives it to Bailey. Bailey looks in, gives back to Calvert. Calvert cross-courts it out to Graham, who fires a three, and he missed it. The rebound comes down to Penn State. Back down the floor come the Nittany Lions, and Michael Jennings with a basketball. Inside to Carlton, who fires it up good. And that was actually Elton Carter, not Carlton. First two for Carter. It's a 17-17 tie. Now, Graham to the left wing. Greg pulls up, gives out to Damon. Bailey bounces to Calvert. Calvert from 15 feet, got it. Calvert Cheney's got 10, and boy, is he off to another hot start tonight. 19-17 score. The Hoosiers on top by two. Cheney is 5-for-6 from the field, which means he is now 14 out of his last 15 shots from the field, including that 9-in-a-row streak against Iowa. Now, driving right, Hayes pumps it and missed it. The rebound to Henderson. Allen clears it out to Greg Graham. Graham across the timeline. Greg pulls back on the right side of the circle, then takes it to the left. Inside pass to Henderson. Up, and he good. Couldn't get it. Got his own rebound. Back up, missed it again. Got his rebound again, and this time he's fouled. Elton Carter is going to be nailed on the personal, his first of the ball game. It looked like Henderson had an easy shot inside that time, and I think he got it off just a touch late, and it was partially blocked, I think, by Amici, and then it was just a rebound battle. Here's Bailey sitting down as Reynolds comes in, and Brian Evans will check in for the first time, and Evans will replace Allen Henderson. Three new faces for Penn State, and we'll pick them up for you when time resumes. Timeout is called. Indiana 19, Penn State 17. 10:36 on the clock. Back after the 60-second network break.
It's the end of the week, and you don't have your lotto cash tickets for Saturday's $9 million jackpot? Why? Isn't $9 million all cash, all at once, enough to buy all the wonderful things you dream about? Isn't $9 million cash worth taking a shot at? Someone's going to win sometime, and it may as well be you. Get to a lottery retailer now and get your chance for $9 million by playing Lotto Cash for Saturday from the Hoosier Lottery, where you gotta play to win.
When was the last time you thought about your electricity? Never, right? Well, there's a reason for that. It's called Indiana's Consumer-Owned Rural Electric Cooperatives. And we've been providing you and a million other people with reliable electric service for 55 years. And we've invested over $2 billion to bring you electricity for conveniences like TVs, refrigerators, toasters, and much more. Of course, there's a reason Indiana's rural electric cooperatives work so hard to serve you. You are, after all, our owners.
State College, Pennsylvania, Rec Hall on the campus of Penn State University, and Indiana leads Penn State 19-17 with 10:36 to go in this first half.
Well, Allen Henderson has already picked up seven rebounds in this basketball game, although he did have a shot blocked by John Amici a moment ago. Amici came into this game with 34 blocks, so he obviously is one of those people that can do that very well. Shooting-wise, both teams exactly the same right now. 8 of 17, 47%. Indiana has hit just two of its last six shots. Penn State has hit just three of its last nine shots. Well, Penn State went back to that zone, Don. They only showed a man-to-man at one time down court. Indiana scored easily. Since then, they've gone back to the zone, and the Hoosiers have had to work for their shots.
Out of the floor for IU, Brian Evans, Chris Reynolds, Greg Graham, Calvert Cheney, and Matt Nover. For Penn State, they have on the floor Deron Hayes along with Elton Carter. Let's see who else. They've changed three players. Steve Weidman's in for the first time as the pass comes into Cheney. Back out to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds spins to the right, looks at the Graham. Greg fires up a three-pointer and got it. Greg Graham buries his first three of the night, and Indiana's taking a 22-17 lead. Here's Weidman bringing the ball up the floor. Also in there is Rashawn Carlton now. And Weidman with the ball, looks inside, having some trouble. Also in there is Michael Joseph for the first time. Now Carlton with the ball, gets it out to Hayes. Hayes kicks it away to Weidman, who pumps the three and missed it. The rebound inside, knocked away and pulled out of there by Joseph. Back to Weidman. Weidman down to the corner. He goes to Carlton. Carlton looks inside, spins, baseline move, a whistle, offensive foul. Rashad Carlton is called for using an arm illegally, and that's his first foul of the ball game. Bruce Parkhill talking to one of his players out there, not unhappy with the call necessarily. 22-17, score IU by five. Reynolds with the basketball in backcourt. Chris to the right side, outside to Greg Graham. Pulls it back to Chris Reynolds. Crosses the circle. There is a man defense again being used by Penn State now. Here's Calvert. Lets it fly from 18. Missed the shot. The rebound comes long to Weidman. Chaney had it going for a while, but he is still playing quite well. Here's the pass in the corner to Carlton. He looks for Joseph. Finds him, who turns on Nover. Fakes, fires it up. Missed the shot inside. Ball batted out of bounds. It'll belong to IU. Hoosiers will have it. 22-17 on the board. Indiana with a five-point lead. Here's Graham giving to Reynolds. And Chris brings it across the timeline. Reynolds lost the handle, got it back, gives to Graham. Graham looks it inside. Can't find Evans, goes to Chaney. We got a whistle, offensive foul against Indiana away from the ball. And Matt Nover just got nailed on it. That'll be his first. That's only the second team foul whistled against Indiana. That's the third turnover against the Hoosiers. And Penn State Nittany Lions have the basketball once again. Weidman will bring it down. Weidman brings it up across the timeline against Reynolds. Bounces in the corner to Joseph. Make it Carlton. Carlton brings it out to the wing. Then looks it inside and fires the shot. No good. Rebound. Batted up. Whistle blows. We got a foul against Penn State. I think Carter got nailed in this one. Elton Carter just got hammered for his second personal foul. That is team foul four against the Nittany Lions. They'll make it five. Indiana will get the basketball once again. Hoosiers have been called for just two team fouls thus far. 8:50 to go, first half. They're letting them play.
They are. Amici's come back in again, Don, as they gave him just a brief rest. Henderson's going to come back in for Indiana.
Michael Jennings is also back in the ball game now for Weidman. Here's the pass. Todd Leary is checked in for the Hoosiers. In the pass goes to Calvert Chaney. Backs it out, looks, bounces it into Nover. Matt turns around, one dribble, puts it up left-handed, got her. Nice move by Nover for his fifth point. Now it's 24-17, and the Hoosiers up to a seven-point lead. Now Michael Jennings across the timeline, slides it right side of the circle, spins left, and threw it away. But it's picked up by Carter. And he traveled, but the officials didn't see it. And the entire coaching staff for IU, except for Bob Knight, got off the bench in a hurry. However, Indiana does come up with a ball.
Yeah, turnover.
So they did turn it over the third of the game. Todd Leary bounces it to Reynolds. Apparently a delayed whistle on the play. Reynolds gives to Leary. Leary looks it right, drives it left, gives it to Calvert Chaney. Chaney cross-courts it to Evans. Brian fakes, drives baseline, 12-foot jumper off the mark, no. And he threw it up an air ball, and he's going to get the chant for a while. Now Carlton looks it in. Having some trouble. Calvert's got him nicely, and here's a steal. Leary picks it up. Todd all the way for the layup, and he missed it. Rebound, Chaney back up, no, but a whistle. Todd Leary misses an easy one inside. So Leary had it to knock in and didn't get the job done. Chaney, however, got fouled. And the whistle was on Rashawn Carlton. That's his second personal. Reynolds and Leary both sit down now. And Damon Bailey and Greg Graham come back in. And we got another timeout call with the score. Indiana 24, Penn State 17, 7:44 on the clock. Back after the 60-second network timeout.
What's clear?
New Crystal Clear Amoco Ultimate Gasoline.
What isn't?
All other premium gasolines.
What's clear?
New Improved Amoco Ultimate is the only premium refined an extra step to remove harmful impurities called PNAs.
PNAs?
Impurities that can rob your engine of performance and contribute to hydrocarbon exhaust emissions.
What's clear?
For unsurpassed performance and a cleaner environment, Crystal clear Amoco Ultimate.
New in this area.
You expect more from a leader.
Say, neighbors, that one of those new snapper lawn tractors I see in your garage?
You betcha. This baby is built tough. And talk about power. A Briggs IC with 12 horses, peerless 5-speed gear drive, 30-inch cutting deck with 6 cutting heights, 32-inch turning radius, 2-year limited warranty.
Boy, you must have run into some cash to buy this snapper tractor a couple of months before the grass needs to be cut.
Oh, not at all. I just use Snap Credit, so I don't have to start paying for it until October. Besides, with snapper tractors starting at $14.99, these babies aren't going to last very long down at the snapper dealer.
You know, neighbor, I think I'll go visit that snapper dealer before the spring rush starts.
Well, back once again at Rec Hall here at Penn State University. The Hoosiers are a 24-17 leader over Penn State, and now you will have the basketball out of bounds underneath their own hoop. Henderson, Brian Evans, Greg Graham, along with Calvert Cheney and Damon Bailey, the lineup for IU. And Penn State has Bartram back in the ballgame now, along with Jennings. I believe Eric Carr is back in. Nope, it is not Carr. It is Elton Carter, who's still in there, along with John Amici. Deron Hayes will be coming back in momentarily.
Penn State reverting back to their shooting. They've hit only 4 of their last 13 shots.
Inbounding will be Bailey. Looks, gets it to Calvert. Cheney on the baseline, brings it out of the dribble. Cheney now lost the handle. He slipped and fell. The ball came out of his hands, and the turnover going to Rashawn Carlton. Carlton with it to Jennings, and he'll bring it down the floor. He carried it and got away with it. Here's the pass inside. It's kicked by Bryant Evans. It'll belong to Penn State out of bounds. Now Deron Hayes will check back in, and Rashawn Carlton will sit down. 7:28 left in the half. Indiana is up right now by 7. Inbounding will be Hayes underneath the Penn State basket. And we're about ready. Now it comes in. The pass comes to Jennings in backcourt. Jennings starts to slide it right. Bounces it out to Bartram. Bartram holds against Bailey, drives baseline, cut off, flips it back to Amici. Amici looks against Evans. He drives, he fires it up, and got it. John Amici gets his first 2 points of the ball game. 24-19 score. Here comes Damon Bailey across the timeline for IU. Bailey on the left wing out to Greg Graham. Graham spins, looks for help, turns around, and gives it back to Bailey. Bailey to Calvert. Cheney bounces back to Damon. Damon outside of the right wing, bounces to Henderson for a turnaround jumper. It's no good, and the rebound comes away to Jennings. Jennings now will bring it back down the floor. Jennings drives it toward the left side. Jennings in backcourt on the move, slides it to the wing, baseline move underneath, puts it up and in. Jennings took it right to the hole that time and got away from his man, and he's got his 4 point. 24-21, the 7-point lead evaporates to 3, and Greg Graham lost the handle out of bounds. Chris Reynolds is going to come back in the ballgame for IU. That's the 5th Hoosier turnover. Also coming in is Michael Joseph once again for Penn State. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
WNJY Delphi Monticello, an affiliate of the Agra America Network. Listen for the latest Agra news every morning at 6:05 and in the noon hour.
Michael Jennings bounces into John Amici. Posts up Henderson, fires the shot, blocked away by Henderson out of bounds. Good defensive effort by Allen Henderson. He continues to play well defensively. Matt Nover getting set to check back in now for IU. Nover may be coming in. He is for Brian Evans. Evans sits down. Nover back in there, and Bartram will inbound for Penn State. Bartram looks. Having trouble. Finally clears it into Joseph. Joseph lost it. A whistle blows. Double dribble call. Traveling violation. That's the 5th turnover on the Nittany Lions. And Bruce Parkhill thought that the ball was touched by an Indiana player that negated the double dribble. But the official saw it otherwise. Here's down low, a pass from Reynolds to Bailey. He lost the handle. They scramble for it, and it's finally picked up in there by Penn State. The Nittany Lions are playing tough. And here is a lost handle. And they call Chris Reynolds for a foul. Reynolds got poked in the eye, I think, and they call a foul against Chris. His first of the contest. So Penn State will get the ball out of bounds on the 13th foul committed on IU. Up the floor comes Michael Jennings. Jennings driving it left side of the circle, fires the shot, good. Jennings has got his sixth shot, or sixth point, I should say. And now it's a one-point game again, 24-23. Here's Reynolds to Bailey. Damon fires a long one. It's off the mark. The rebound inside, knocked away and picked up by Bartram, and a foul call on Henderson. That's Allen Henderson's second personal foul. 5:22 to go, first half. Penn State hanging tough right now, gaining confidence as you go, and of course here in Rec Hall they play well.
Well, they've got six straight points right now against Indiana.
They could retake the lead if they convert here. Jennings against Reynolds, pitches it left side. It comes to Michael Joseph. Back out to Amici. Amici fires off to Hayes, who pumps the jump shot. No good. To the rebound, Calvert Cheney for Indiana. Clears to Reynolds. Up the floor, Chris goes. Right side drive all the way. Puts it up and got it. Chris Reynolds for his first field goal. 26-23, Indiana by three. 4:51 and a half. Michael Jennings across the timeline. Jennings gets it to Bartram. Bartram turns and looks inside. Bartram, right side pass to Amici. Amici holds on the perimeter, then pumps a three-point shot. No good, and the rebound comes off to Henderson. Allen gives to Reynolds. Reynolds pushes it up the floor. Right side to Bailey. Inside, nice move up and in. And Damon scores a big field goal there, his first of the game. 28-23. Nice feed by Reynolds. Good delivery of that pass. Now Penn State's Michael Jennings to the right side on the circle. Gives it to Bartram, top of the key. A whistle away from the ball. Foul called against Penn State's John Amici. Amici gets nailed in his first foul. So Indiana will go to the 1-1 for the first time in the ball game with 4:09 on the clock here in the first half. And I believe it'll be Matt Nover going to the line. Nover with 5 points in this contest, hitting 51% of his free tosses on the year, only 45% from the line in Big Ten play. But tonight, he's 1-1. So Nover at the line with a 1-1 situation. And he missed it. The rebound of Amici for Penn State. 28-23, IU by five. Nittany Lion ball. Steve Weidman back in the game, brings it across the timeline. Weidman, for Jennings in the lineup. Here's the pass to Hayes, to Amici down low. The ball batted out of bounds by Bailey on a feed to Michael Joseph. So Indiana playing good inside defense that time. And we got another timeout. Score, Indiana 28, Penn State 23. 3:53 to go in the first half. Back after the 60-second break, this is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Have you ever thought about how much work your brakes do every day? You know, the average set of brakes stops your car safely over 100 times daily, and that's not counting when you slow down. Your safety, as well as the safety of your family, depends on your brakes. That's why Jim's Tune-Up take a great deal of pride in providing the very best in brake service. All brake jobs include a complete four-wheel check and turning of the drums or rotors if necessary. And you can even get pads that are guaranteed for as long as you own that car. See Jim's Tune-Up in Monticello today on First Street under the big smokestack.
Main Street Flooring is planning great Valentine's Day specials.
And you're listening to Joy 103, where you get a wake-up call. It's every weekday morning at 5 o'clock with NBC's First Light and your host, Dirk Van.
Well, back once again at Rec Hall, Penn State University, where Indiana holds a 5-point lead with 3:53 to go in this first half of play.
Well, these fans here tonight, about 7,200 of them, that's 400 more than capacity, with 400 standing around the back up here along the top. But Indiana right now with a 5-point lead, they're shooting 46% on 12 of 26. They've hit two of their last four since the last timeout. Penn State now has dropped down to 42% shooting, 11 of 26.
They've hit three of their last six. Penn State got off to a rip-roaring start, built up a five-point lead when they hit four of their first seven shots. But since then, their shooting has come down. Unfortunately, Indiana's shooting has not been much better.
Penn State basketball. Inbounding will be Greg Bikram. Bikram looks, gets it in. It comes to Deron Hayes against Bailey. Hayes on the dribble. Left wing, fires a 15-foot four shot. No good. Rebound, Allen Henderson. Clears to Reynolds. Across the timeline to Bailey. Bailey left wing holds high. Looks it in. Cross courts to Calvert. Cheney for a three try, and it is no good. Rebound, Matt Nover. Nover inside, back up, and couldn't get a rebound. Tip, no good. And Deron Hayes got the board and then stepped out of bounds. Indiana will get it out of bounds underneath their own hoop. Damon Bailey will trigger the inbound pass. Bailey gets it to Henderson. He fires the jumper right away, missed it, and Damon Bailey comes up with the rebound. Off to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds drives inside, gets it to Calvert for a slam dunk. And Cheney's got his 12th point of the ball game. Incidentally, Calvert has moved into the number four spot in career Big Ten points, replacing Rick Mount in that position. He needed five coming into tonight's game. The right side pass comes to Bikram for the Penn State Nittany Lions. The Hoosiers back up to a seven-point lead. Weidman goes to Bikram, who fires off the glass and got it. Bikram has his seventh point. 30-25, Indiana, a five-point leader. Reynolds gives to Damon Bailey. 2:45 to go in the half. Reynolds back to Damon, inside to Calvert, down low to Henderson. He fakes again, puts it up and scores. Allen Henderson with a couple of nice shot fakes and finally got Amici off his feet, scores his eighth point. 32-25, Indiana by seven again. Across the timeline, Weidman for Penn State, down to the baseline, brings it back out of the wing. Gave up the dribble, looks for help, bounces to Bikram. Bikram on the baseline is fouled by Bailey. Damon called for a foul. He was on Bartram's back. And so it's 32-25, Indiana by seven. Penn State basketball. Fourth team foul whistle against the Hoosiers, so Penn State still not in the 1-1. 2:20 remaining in this first half of play. The inbound pass comes from Bartram. He holds, pitches it backcourt to Michael Jennings. Jennings goes right to Bikram. Bikram backs it out of the dribble. Spins, drives it left, pulls up, fires, and got it. Bikram with a nice move for his ninth point. 32-27. Indiana lead cut to five. Here's Chris Reynolds to Damon Bailey. Again, they go to the zone defense. Now Reynolds looks inside against it. Back out to Bailey. Damon bounces to Nover. Nover down low left. He'll pull it back out to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds dribbles it in the paint, gets it down low to Calvert. Cheney in the baseline backs it out. Calvert gives it to Damon Bailey on the right side of the circle. Damon holds. Back left to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds looks it low. Back to Damon. Bailey back to Reynolds. Now cross courts to Calvert. He drives baseline, shoots it up, missed it. Rebound tipped up by Allen Henderson. Henderson's got his 10th point of the ball game. A beautiful tip in. 34-27. IU a seven-point leader again. Right side, Jennings goes to Bikram baseline. Inside pass knocked away, and Reynolds has got it. And a whistle and a foul call on Reynolds. Reynolds gets nailed on his second foul. Penn State again will get the basketball out of bounds. 1:11 to go in the first half of play. Knight didn't like that last call.
Well, Henderson has given himself a good show here today. He's 4 of 8 shooting, but he's also got 10 rebounds already in this half.
Inbounding will be Deron Hayes. Hayes slaps it one time. Gets it inside to Jennings, who fires the jump shot. Got it. Jennings now has his 8th point. He is playing well tonight, and it's 34-29. Now Reynolds brings it across the timeline. Backcourt pass to Damon. 53 seconds left in the half. Back out to Bailey. Bailey to the right wing. Fires to Chris Reynolds. Reynolds back to Bailey. Damon holds on the wing, looks it low, comes back to Reynolds, cross courts to Calvert. Cheney back outside to Chris, inside and over. Jump shot by Matt is no good. Rebound batted up and finally pulled out of there by Amici. Penn State within five and a chance to cut it even closer. We're inside 30 seconds and Penn State will probably go for the last shot. Jennings to the right side to Deron Hayes. Hayes on the baseline pitches it out, and Chris Reynolds bats it out of bounds. Again, Bob Knight, I don't think like that call much, but he'll get no satisfaction as Deron Hayes will inbound. He gets it in. It comes to Michael Jennings. 15 seconds left in the half. Now, Jennings in backcourt. Slides it right. Comes back out. Down to 8 seconds. Jennings still near the midcourt line. Down to 5 seconds. Jennings spins, drives, fires a three, and got it. Michael Jennings scores as the horn closes out the first half of play. And the Penn State Nittany Lions, on their home floor, find some magic. They're within two at the break. Indiana 34, Penn State 32. We'll be back with our halftime show after we pause for the 60-second network timeout.
Thinking of selling your home? Let the professionals at Century 21 ease the stress. Even under the best circumstances, selling a house comes with a certain amount of anxiety. The key to minimizing it is selecting a sales associate that has the knowledge and sensitivity to take you comfortably through the process, which is why you should contact one of the sales associates at your local Century 21 office or call 1-800-886-4849. Just tell us what you want. It's as good as done. Each office independently owned and operated.
University Broadcasting Company is proud to bring you IU basketball. University Broadcasting serves Indiana with the finest in sports radio. University Broadcasting Company operates 2 sports networks and 7 radio stations, including WHHH, Hoosier 96 in Indianapolis, WBWB, B97 in Bloomington, WGCT in Ellettsville, and WAZY, Z96 in Lafayette. University Broadcasting Company is Indiana's radio broadcasting company. Thanks for listening.
Well, back once again at Rec Hall. We are at halftime. Penn State trailing Indiana, the number one ranked team of the country, by just 2 at the break. Indiana 34, Penn State 32. A look at the individual scoring in this first half of play. Steve Weidman did not score or foul. This is Penn State scoring we're speaking of. Michael Jennings fired in 5 field goals, the last a 3-pointer, and it closed out the first half scoring. He has 11 first half points. He's been on fire. John Amici with 1 field goal, 2 points, and a foul. Deron Hayes, 3 field goals, 6 points, no fouls. Eric Carr, a field goal, 2 points and 1 foul. Greg Bartram with 4 field goals, one of those a 3, 9 points and no fouls. Rashawn Carlton did not score, picked up 2 personals. Michael Joseph had no points and no fouls. And Elton Carter with a field goal, 2 points and 2 personals. So Penn State at the half, led by Michael Jennings, 11 points and 9 out of Greg Bartram. The guards tonight so far doing the job for Penn State. For Indiana, Chris Reynolds has a field goal for 2 points and 2 fouls. Damon Bailey has 1 field goal, 2 points and 1 foul. Matt Nover with a pair of field goals and a free throw, 5 points, 1 foul. Calbert Cheney's thrown in 6 field goals, 12 first half points and no fouls. Alan Henderson has 4 field goals, 2 free throws, 10 first half points and 2 fouls. Greg Graham with a field goal, a 3-pointer. He has 3 points and no fouls. Bryant Evans and Todd Leary both played, neither scored nor fouled. So Indiana at the break, 2 players in double figures, Cheney with 12, Henderson with 10. Max, look at those team stats.
Well, Penn State has the advantage as far as the shooting is concerned. They've hit 48% of their shots on 15 of 31. Indiana's just 44% on 15 of 34. So once again, Indiana's shooting woes continue to cause them problems. From three-point range, Penn State is 2 of 6. Indiana is 1 of 6. Indiana went to the line 4 times, hit 3 of them. Penn State did not make it to the line here in this first half of play. Rebounding, Indiana out-rebounding Penn State by an 18 to 15 margin. The turnovers, Indiana was 6 and Penn State with 7 turnovers in the first half of play. Calbert Cheney is 6 of 10. He had a great start, but he has missed 3 of the last 4 shots that he's taken. Alan Henderson is 4 of 9 in the half. Matt Nover has hit 2 out of 5. Greg Graham, who has not had a good game so far, 1 of 3. That was a 3-pointer. Damon Bailey is 1 of 4. Chris Reynolds, 1 of 1. Todd Leary, 0 of 1. And Brian Evans, 0 for 1. And Penn State was shot only 25% in the first half against Indiana in Bloomington. Has been much better, as we mentioned. Ronde Hayes, 3 of 6 in this first half. Eric Cart, one of three. Amici is one of four. But Michael Jennings, who was three of seven in the first game, hit five out of six in his first half. And Greg Bartram, who was one of four, hit four out of six in the first half. So the Nittany Lions obviously doing much, much better here in this first half than they did against the Hoosiers in Bloomington. As a matter of fact, at one point they had a five-point lead at 9-4. Indiana has had a couple of 3 7-point leads, but it's a close one here at halftime. Just 34-32, Indiana up by a mere 2 points.
All right, we'll be back with our halftime guest, the head football coach of Penn State, Joe Paterno, after we pause for this 60-second timeout. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
I stopped in a muffler shop the other day to see about their so-called guaranteed muffler service. What I saw was this guy offering me the same muffler he had just put on a 1959 Packard. Come on, not all cars are the same, and neither are their muffler systems. A muffler and exhaust system is an important part of your car's performance. At Jim's Tune-Up Center, their muffler service might cost you a little more, but when you leave, you're going to have a big A muffler designed especially for your car or light truck, and it's going to be warrantied for as long as you own that car. That's Jim's Tune-Up Center in Monticello on First Street under the big smokestack.
And you're listening to Joy 103, where we keep you up to date with a half hour of farm news. It's every morning before 6 o'clock here on WNJY Joy 103.
Giving the Hoosiers all they want here in this first half of play as they trail Indiana by a 34-32 margin. Well, Joe Paterno, the football coach here at Penn State, seated alongside us. And Joe, let me say that we back a little farther in the Midwest. When we think of Penn State, we think of Joe Paterno. I'm not sure we think of anything else, and that's a real compliment to you. You've been here a long time.
Well, that's nice of you to say that, because, you know, we've got great admiration for Bobby Knight in Indiana, and a lot of people around here don't realize what a quality guy Bill Mallory is in your football program. I've gotten to know Bill the last couple of years going to Big Ten meetings, and, you know, we're as excited as our people are here to be playing in this basketball game, and being in the Big Ten is really up the level of enthusiasm and intensity of our crowd and our fans, and I think tonight epitomizes exactly what happened. I think the same thing's going to happen with some playing football.
I recall you're saying at the first press conference in Chicago just after Penn State had come in that they had given you new life. A man that was about 64, 65 at that point, as I recall.
That's right.
That you took on a whole new attitude.
Well, Rainey Portland, our women's basketball coach, said it's like taking on a new job without having to move. And that's exactly right. This whole campus athletically has changed so much, and it's been amazing to see the difference. Our refs just talk about winning Big Ten championships. Our women's basketball is very competitive, and, you know, probably the best. As good a women's basketball conference as there is right now. And then, we're not quite there yet in basketball, but we're only a couple players away, and we think we got a great young coach. And I honestly believe when we finish our new arena, which will be done in about 3 years, and with Parkville here and the kind of recruiting he's doing, we're going to be a force in the Big Ten in 4 or 5 years. I don't think any question about it. And hopefully our football will be.
Are you looking forward to getting into it with your football team?
Oh, absolutely. No, we're excited about it. We really are. And we've got some big games up here. With the 1,000th game Penn State's going to play, and it's in a collegiate football history, will be against Michigan here on this campus in October. So that's going to be a big game, and there's a lot of excitement about it already.
I understand you picked Indiana for your homecoming.
Well, I told... Well, that's great. Indiana is so much like we are. The size of the town, the kind of school it is, there's a lot of things very similar to it, and I think before it's all over, we're going to have a very close rivalry.
Joe, I'll come back. I'd like to talk to you some more, but right now I need to pause 60 seconds. We're at halftime. Indiana leading Penn State 34-32. Let's pause 60 seconds. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Be smart. Let 1993 bring you something free. At Budget Car and Truck Rental, after you rent any car or van 5 times, you get a free day rental on an economy through full-size car. Budget provides you with a personalized frequent renter card to use every time you rent.
It's good at all budget rent-a-car of Central Indiana locations. So, when you need an economy car, mid-size car, full-size car, luxury car, minivan with unlimited mileage and special daily, weekly, and weekend rates, call Budget. Be smart. Start off 1993 with a guarantee of something free. Call now and reserve a new Buick Regal custom sedan with power windows and cassette, a sporty Pontiac Grand Prix, or a spacious Pontiac Transport SE minivan, and you'll be on the road to your free day rental. Whether for business or pleasure, the more you rent, the more free days you get. Budget Car and Truck Rental, located at 3305 South Street and at the Purdue Airport in Lafayette. Call today, 743-3987. That's 743-3987. Budget, where you get the best deals on wheels.
Once again, back at Penn State University, where Indiana's playing the Penn State Nittany Lions tonight and leading 34-32 at halftime. We're talking with Joe Paterno, the football coach at Penn State here. Joe, as you did your recruiting this year, going into the Big Ten, did you see any difference? Was there any significant change in the recruiting that you ran into people?
Not really. I think a couple of Big Ten schools may have done a little better job in the East than they had done previously. Wisconsin got an outstanding football player that we were interested in New England. And Michigan took a couple of top-notch players out of this state. But Michigan is, you know, will do that to you. Michigan does a great job recruiting. But overall, I thought it went about the same. We got a couple of kids out of Ohio that maybe we would not have gotten if we had not been in the Big Ten. Got a kid out of Chicago. But overall, I don't think there was much difference. I really didn't.
The Rose Bowl is the big package you're trying to get to, isn't it?
Absolutely. I've been to almost all the bowls, and I'd like to. It'd be fun to take a team to the Rose Bowl, but I'm not as. I'm a little bit more realistic than a lot of our fans. There's an awful lot of football teams that have been trying to get there in the last few years, haven't been able to do it. So we got a tough job out of us, but that's our goal. We'd like to get the Rose Bowl.
Joe, have you had any personal relationship with Bob Knight over the years?
I've known Bob since Bob was a young coach at West Point. He and I run a couple of clinics together. In fact, when I was visiting with him in his locker room Friday game, he was teasing me back in 1968. He wanted the job here at Penn State. And it came down to Bobby, who was at West Point that time, and John Bach. And we took John Bach. And I keep kidding Bob. He's been angry ever since. The reason they took Bobby was so young at that time.
Well, he certainly was a young coach when he came to Indiana, and obviously has been a very good basketball coach over the years.
And, you know, unfortunately, the public has such a distorted view of the guy. He's such a great guy, and great for basketball, and I'd like to think he's a good friend of mine. I really, Bobby, I have a tremendous amount of respect for him. I mean that, I'm not saying that to say it. I mean that very sincerely.
Joe, as you look at the Big Ten football coming up this fall, Michigan, I suppose, you still consider the big competition, Ohio State, as far as the Big Ten race is concerned?
Well, you know, again, I haven't had a chance to look enough at the personnel in that league, but I've talked to some people, and I think Michigan looks like they would probably have more people than anybody else. And they recruited really well, at least against the people we recruited. Ohio State, he's got a lot of people back, I understand. And then Wisconsin's getting better. Indiana, Bill Mallory does such a good job. Maybe gets a quarterback or another big play guy in there and plays such solid football. A good young coach at Purdue. Iowa, Hayden's always going to come up. Illinois tied Michigan at the end. So I don't know enough, really, to tell you exactly what's going to happen because we didn't play them last year. But I look at the results, and I think the league is probably going to be maybe a better league next year than it's been for a while.
Got about 10 seconds, Joe. How good are you going to be this year compared to last year?
Well, we'll be better than we were last year. Well, how good that is, I don't know. We weren't very good last year. We were very erratic. But I think we'll be a better football team next year.
Joe Paterno, we thank you very much for coming by. We look forward to coming back out here next fall when we play against you in that nice big stadium we came by.
Well, it's great to be a member of the Big Ten.
All right. Thank you very much. Coach Joe Paterno, the football coach here at Penn State University. And we will be seeing him later in the fall, of course. Well, here at Penn State tonight, Indiana has their hands full with a 34-32 lead at halftime. As we mentioned, Indiana shooting only 44%. Penn State shooting 48%. Indiana is out rebounding by a 20-16 margin officially over Penn State. But Indiana still having problems with its guards play tonight, not getting much scoring, and as a result, Indiana is struggling to get things going. Well, Don, these two ball clubs have returned to the playing court. We're going to see another 20 minutes, and obviously this game is not in the bag as it was last time Indiana played Penn State.
Well, they're getting everybody's best shot this year. This team, I think, is aware of that, and how they play, of course, in the next 5 or 6 minutes may determine whether this ball game will go down to the wire or not. We'll wait and see. We'll be back right after we pause for the 60-second network timeout.
Hear that?
Wow, it even sounds warm. Is it because my ears are big?
No, it's because I chose gas heat, Dumbo.
Today's natural gas heating technology means comfort and savings. It's the ideal energy for your home.
When my shower ran out of hot water, I had this little trick to keep me warm. I used to sing. Well, I mean, it's safer than dancing, isn't it? Okay, prettier too.
Natural gas technology means more hot water for less. It's the ideal energy for your family.
Oh, nice apron. Love the ruffles.
Oh, thanks. But you know, cooking with natural gas is a breeze with pilotless ignition and sealed burners. I'll cook dinner for once.
Oh, no, dear. You'll cook dinner for one.
Natural gas is what's new in today's kitchens. It's the ideal energy for cooking. For new information on today's natural gas technology and the ideal energy, call Indiana Gas at 1-800-777-4414.
Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network. Some of our guests at halftime receive a gift certificate from D-Dad's Gentlemen's and Ladies Clothier of Indianapolis. D-Dad's has updated classic clothing, sportswear, and accessories for men and women. They're open daily Monday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 6, and on Wednesday and Thursday open till 9. D-Dad's Clothing to complement your lifestyle in West 86th Street at Township Line Road in the Northville Mall in Indianapolis. Second half basketball starts with Penn State in possession, and De'Ron Hayes immediately fires one up, no good. He gets his own rebound, fires it into Machi, puts it up and in. John Amici on the rebound basket for his fourth point. It's a tie ball game at 34. Chris Reynolds to Todd Leary. Back outside to Reynolds. Now to Calvert. Chaney looks inside. Bounces it off. It comes to Allen Henderson, who goes back to Chaney, who fires and misses. The rebound comes away to Penn State. We have a new all-time attendance record tonight. More on that momentarily. Here's the pass almost stolen away by IU. Now inside it comes, back out it goes to Jennings, who pumps another three and drills it again. Michael Jennings has his 14th point of the ball game. He hit the three-point field goal just before the first half closed out, and he bangs another one home there to give Penn State a three-point lead. Reynolds back to Leary. Todd on the right wing to Chris Reynolds, left side to Calvert. Now to Henderson. Henderson looks inside. On the wing, flips it outside to Reynolds. Back right to Todd Leary. Leary on the wing again to Reynolds. Left side, and threw the ball away. Threw it right off the chest of Allen Henderson. And Penn State's got the rebound, or rather the loose ball, and here comes Jennings on the right side. He gets it out to Bartram. Bartram looks for help, turns around. Having trouble. Fires it backcourt. It comes away to Amici. Now off to Jennings. Right side to De'Ron Hayes, who drives baseline, fires it up, and couldn't get it. Rebound batted away, knocked off of Henderson out of bounds, and a good play by Eric Carr. The Hoosiers having trouble getting started here in the first 2 minutes of the second half. They've been outscored. Here's a jumper by Jennings again, this time short. Got his own rebound and puts it in. Jennings has got 16 points. Indiana is a 39-34 five-point trailer, and Bob Knight brings Bailey and Graham off the bench. Here's Leary left wing. Back outside to Reynolds, down to Calvert, down low to Henderson, whose jump shot is good. Allen Henderson scores his 12th point of the ball game, and the Hoosiers trail by three again, 39-36. First two of the second half by Indiana. Now Jennings gives it right side. It goes to Bartram. Bartram On the wing, the baseline to Hayes. Deron Hayes guarded by Calvert Cheney. A whistle away from the ball. Foul called on Matt Mover. Mover nailed on the personal, I believe his second of the ball game. Greg Graham and Damon Bailey now will check into the Hoosier lineup. And let's see who's going to the sideline. It'll be Reynolds. Todd Leary's still in there. Somebody's going to have to go out. I guess it's Nover. So Matt Nover goes to the sideline. So Nover and Reynolds out of the ball game. Indiana going with a very small lineup right now. Henderson and Cheney, the front liners, and three guards. Here's the inbound to Jennings outside to Bartram. Bartram goes right side to Hayes, who fires it up. No good. Rebound to Machi, and it's stripped away, and a foul call on Calvert Cheney. That's Calvert's first foul of the ball game. The second team foul whistle on Indiana. And with 17:28 to go in this contest, the Hoosiers are down 39-36 with Amici going to the line.
Right now, Penn State really controlling the boards down there, particularly the offensive boards.
John Amici with 4 points to his credit, a field goal in each half thus far, 72% free throw shooter, and he drills that one for his fifth point of the ball game. It's back to a 4-point Penn State lead. The Nittany Lions. As Amici scores his 6 point. Penn State leads it 5-41-36. And the fans have been on their feet for a long time here. Here is Leary to Calvert Cheney. Back to Leary. Todd again to Calvert. He fakes the three. Fires it to Bailey. Bailey slides it left. Gets it back to Cheney. Down low to Henderson. Inside. Puts it up and got the roll. Allen Henderson with both of the baskets in the second half thus far for IU. 41-38. Inbound pass deflected away. Stolen by Damon Bailey and Greg Graham. Graham is the guy who tipped it loose. Here is Leary out to Calvert. Calvert fakes, drives it right, lost the handle. Back he comes to Leary with a pass. And a whistle away from the ball. This time it's called on Penn State. This one goes on Eric Carr. That'll be his second foul of the ball game. So Carr nailed on the personal. And that's the guy we had listed for just one in the first half. He actually had two, so that's his third. So Carr now with three. Indiana basketball again. The Hoosiers down by three. Bailey, right side to Calvert. Cheney inside, jumps it up, missed the shot. Rebound Henderson, back up he goes, couldn't get it. Rebound to Amici for Penn State. Neither one of those shots by Cheney or Henderson was on balance at all. Here's Bartram for the Nittany Lions. Left side pass to Deron Hayes. Inside it goes to Amici. Batted away. Carr picks it up out to Jennings. Now to Hayes again. Down low to Amici. Amici turns. Forces it up. No. And we got a foul call. And Cheney just got another one. Albert Cheney just picked up his second personal. And 41-38 the score, Penn State by three. But again, John Amici will go to the free throw line for the Nittany Lions. 16:15 to go in this final half of play. And Penn State giving the Hoosiers all they want here tonight at Rec Hall. The shot, good. Amici has hit 7 points now in the ball game, and he's connected on three consecutive free throws here in the second half to go along with a field goal. And number two is also good. 8 points for John Amici, and the Hoosiers are down five again, 43-38. Here comes Todd Leary across the timeline to the right side. Stops and clears to Graham. Greg fakes, drives, bounces back outside, threw it away. Jennings lost it out of bounds. Jennings apparently kicked it out. The Penn State folks thought that it was off of Indiana. Leary inbounds to Bailey, back to Leary. Todd directs some traffic, slides it to the right wing on the dribble to Greg Graham outside. Graham now looks it inside, comes back to Bailey. Damon to Henderson, turns, looks, and finally clears it out to Greg Graham. Graham down low, fires it off the glass. He missed the shot. Rebound, foul on Damon Bailey. Bailey picks up his second. That's the fourth team foul, I believe, on Indiana in the second half. And timeout is called. The score. Indiana trails Penn State 43-38 with 15:42 to go. We'll be back after the 60-second network timeout.
In the Hoosier State. State Farm is there with a free service for Indiana families. Whether you're insured with State Farm or not, call a State Farm agent. Ask about a free family insurance checkup for your car, home, life, and health insurance. Find out where you stand. The advice is free, and the decisions are yours.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
To defend your soybeans against weeds, you need power. You need control. You need consistency. You need this squadron. Squadron Herbicide, for a higher level of soybean weed control. See your Cyanamid AgriCenter dealer. Read and follow label directions.
Well, Indiana's in a fight. The Hoosiers are down 43-38 to Penn State with 15:42 to go in this basketball game. 7,540, the official attendance here tonight. Max, the third largest crowd in Penn State history, and that's probably the biggest since the fire marshal started interceding.
Well, they're making lots of noise here tonight because they've got a lot of things to make noise about. They have held Indiana to just 4 points in the first 4 minutes of this second half. Indiana's overall shooting now has dropped to 42%. They've hit only 2 of 6 this half. Penn State's now shooting 47%. They've hit 3 out of 7. But the rebounding, Penn State has out-rebounded Indiana 6-3 in this half. And I think that's probably been the most significant thing, as both teams has turned it over a couple of times here in the second half.
Starting to get the feeling, Max, you don't like to win the first one by 48?
Well, I do, and this is a tough situation to be in right now.
Up the floor, Michael Jennings for the Nittany Lions. And what a pick was set by John Amici. Greg Ram ran right into it, but give him credit, he didn't go down. Now on the right side, Bartram, a whistle blows. What do we got? Violation of 5-second call against Penn State. So the turnover is the 10th on the Nittany Lions. It gives the ball back to IU. Here comes Todd Leary across the timeline. Leary drives it toward the right, comes back to the left, then stops top of the key, still in the dribble, however, then drives it to the wing left, out to Damon Bailey. Bailey fakes, he drives, and a whistle. Traveling violation. So Indiana turns it over again. So Penn State has it with a 5-point lead and 15:14 on the clock. The inbound pass comes to Jennings. Across the timeline he goes. In backcourt on the dribble to the left side. He gives it off to Carr. Outside to Bartram. Bartram guarded by Greg Graham. Looks it left. And finally clears it away. It comes off to Carr. Carr drives it baseline right. Fires it up. And off the rim, no. Rebound battle for. And Calvert-Cheney's got the board. He clears it outside to Leary. Todd across the timeline. Leary in backcourt backs it out of there. Leary now to the left side to Henderson. Allen lets it fly and drills it. Allen Henderson's had the good shooting touch tonight. He's got 16 now. 43-40. Indiana down 3. 14:31 at the clock. Here comes DeRon Hayes. He'll bring it up against Baylor. Drives it toward the left side of the wing to the baseline and fires the shot. No rebound. Batted up by Cheney, but Hayes comes up with it again. A double team. He's in a bit of trouble, gets it to Carr. Right side pass to Bartram for a 3-try. He missed it inside, and Henderson is tied up inside by 2 Penn State players. The jump ball possession goes to Indiana. So Indiana will have the basketball and a chance to cut into that 3-point lead now.
Well, Henderson has all 6 of Indiana's points in this second half.
So the Hoosiers still struggling with their shooting touch, with the exception of 1 or 2 players a ball game. They can't get everybody hot at the same time, it would appear. Here comes Leary across the timeline. Leary to the left wing. Jump cross-court pass goes to Bailey. Down to the corner to Calvert. Calvert drives and lost the handle. Got it back. Gives to Bailey. Bailey to Leary. Leary left side of the circle. Fakes it right. Gives it to Bailey top of the key. Damon. Gives it back to Greg Graham for a 3-try. Missed it. Rebound inside Calvert. Knocked away. Scramble for it. Picked up by Michael Jennings. And a foul call on Greg Graham. So Greg Graham picks up his first foul of the ball game. And Penn State gets the ball back, leading by three at 43-40. And Rashawn Carlton has come back in the ballgame now for the Nittany Lions. With the basketball, Michael Jennings will bring it down, across the timeline, spins in backcourt, takes it left, it comes away, new face in the game also, Elton Carter back in there. Carter gives to Bartram. Bartram, spin dribble against Graham, left side pass to Jennings. Jennings brings it back in backcourt, then slides it back left, goes to the baseline, pulls up, fires it, block shot by Henderson easily, off to Todd Leary. Leary across the timeline, bounces left to Calvert Cheney. He takes it inside, passes nicely to Graham, scores, and a foul. Nice feed by Calvert Cheney. Greg Graham picks up his fifth point of the game and will go to the line with a chance at a three-point play here that could tie things up at 43. The foul call goes against Elton Carter. That's his third personal. And to the stripe, Greg Graham, who has scored five now in the game. He has been exceptional from the free throw line in Big Ten play, and he drills that one, his sixth point of the contest. 91% free throw shooting by Greg Graham in Big Ten action. 43-43 tie, 13:05 to go. Here across the timeline, Michael Jennings. Jennings in backcourt, looks at right side, finally gets it to Bartram on the wing right. Bartram holds, back outside to Carter. Now left side, it comes off to Jennings. Jennings back to Rashawn Carlton. He fires the long three and got it. Rashawn Carlton's first basket of the game is a three-point bomb. 46-43 Penn State. Here's Todd Leary to Damon Bailey. Offside to Greg Graham. Graham fakes back to Damon. Damon fakes and drives it inside. Passes to Calvert, and his shot is blocked away, but it's going to be goaltending. Calvert Cheney's first two of the second half on a goaltend. He's got 14. Indiana's down by one, 46-45. Here comes Deron Hayes back in the game for Greg Bartram. And with the ball is Carlton. He inbounds to Steve Weidman, who's also checked in now. Weidman will bring it up for Penn State. He takes it to the right side, brings it back out in backcourt, now to Amici in the circle. Amici turns around, looks for help, clears it off, it goes to Weidman. Weidman back outside to Carlton, again to Weidman. Weidman bounces right wing to Deron Hayes. Deron Hayes flies it back outside to Carter. Back left, it comes to Weidman. Now top of the key to Carlton. He goes right to Carter. He drives right, fires the shot up and missed it. Rebound, Calvert Cheney for IU. The break is on. Here's Bailey. Five on three. Left side to Graham. Inside, puts it up. No blocking foul against Penn State. They thought Greg Graham should have been nailed for the travel, but the official didn't call it, and Greg Graham will go to the free throw line. And Indiana now sends Matt Nover back into the ballgame, and Allen Henderson will get a rest. Graham to the stripe has fired in six so far in this contest, and Greg will have two shots coming here. 11:52 to go. He can tie it with his first. Graham fires the first one in the air. Got it. Nothing but net. He's got seven, and the Hoosiers have tied the ballgame again at 46-all. Graham now with one more attempt could give Indiana their first lead of the second half, and it is no good. The rebound comes off to John Amici, and Amici gives to Steve Weidman, and Weidman will bring it down the floor. Across the timeline right, Weidman to the wing on the wing, right side, gets it into Amici, turnaround shot, good, and a foul. Over just got nailed in his third personal foul, and John Amici just drilled his 10th point of the game and has a chance at another three-point play. 48-46, Penn State, and the Nittany Lions are here to stay tonight, it would appear. Indiana trying to break out of it, and they can't do it. In fact, it's just tough enough for them to get a lead in this game. Amici misses the free one, and Greg Graham's got the rebound. It's 48-46, Penn State by two. Graham to Damon Bailey. Bailey on the left side of the circle, tries to penetrate, can, gets it out to Todd Leary. Leary back to Damon for a three try, and he got it. Damon Bailey's first field goal of the second half, his fifth point of the game, and it's a huge three as Indiana gets the lead back. 49-48 IU. Here is Weidman on the right side of the circle. Bounces to Amici. Amici looks inside. He comes left to Rashawn Carlton. He jumps and hits Rashawn Carlton. as his fifth point of the ball game, and Penn State takes the lead back by one. Now, Graham goes right to Leary. Leary back outside. Gets it to Bailey. Bailey back to Leary. Leary on the right side of the circle. Hooks it back to Bailey. Now to Graham. Graham looks in. Fires to Damon. Damon turns around and clears to Graham. He fires up a three. It's short. Rebound Nover. Back up he goes and got it with the left hand. Matt Nover's seventh point. Indiana by one. 51-50 as the lead seesaws. 10.5 minutes to go. Now Weidman across the timeline. Weidman on the dribble against Leary to the right wing. Weidman holds, looks for help. Clears it outside to Hayes. Left side to Carlton. Three on the way. Got it. Rashawn Carlton's second three. His eighth point of the ball game, all in the second half, and Penn State leads by two again. Here is Damon Bailey. Bailey out to Graham. Graham looks at left, lost the handle, got it back, gives to Todd Leary. Leary pulls up, fakes, takes it to the left side, gets it back to Greg Graham. Graham now turns around, looks for help, having trouble. Finally clears to Todd Leary. Leary bounces to Bailey. Three on the way by Damon. No good this time. Rebound Greg Graham inside, and he is fouled. Rashawn Carlton didn't like the call, but he got number three. Indiana will have it at the free throw line, and again it'll be Greg Graham going to the stripe. 53-51, Penn State 5-2, 9:38 to go in this basketball game, Max. And this ball game is tough.
It certainly is. Penn State's playing excellent defense. They're not giving Indiana much underneath. All the shots that Indiana's getting open are outside. They're going to let Indiana try to beat them with the long shot. And it's working very well. Early on, they were using a zone. Now they're mixing it up a lot. But either way, they're doing an excellent job.
Graham can tie it if he hits them both. He's got two coming. The first is in. And now he has his eighth point of the ball game. So, Greg, trying to tie it up at 53 with conversion number two. 9:38 left in the half, in the final half of play. And he missed it. The rebound comes up to Elton Carter, and Penn State's on the attack with a one-point lead. Across the timeline, Michael Jennings, who replaced Steve Weidman in the lineup. Jennings bounces it off. It comes to Carter down low to Carlton. Carlton backs it back out. Bounces inside the car. And he missed the shot and the rebound, or make that Carter, and Indiana comes up with the board. Here's Todd Leary. Leary slows, slides it to the left side. Todd now works against Jennings, brings it out to Damon. Bailey in the lane, gives it back to Todd Leary for a three try. Got it! Huge bucket for Indiana. Todd Leary's first points of the night on a three. 55-53, and Indiana back on top by two. Now Jennings the other way. Leary got knocked down by a pick by Amici. Here's a jump shot, no good by Penn State, and it goes behind the backboard. Indiana gets the ball. Timeout called. Indiana 55, Penn State 53. 8:47 to go. Back after the 60-second network timeout.
Hi, this is Willard Scott for True Value. We'd like to wish the Indiana University basketball team, better known as the Hoosiers, a great season. A high-flying slam dunk can really dazzle the fans. But True Value has some dazzle of its own. It's the Dollar Dazzler Circular. You'll find everything for your home, from extension cords and work gloves to toolboxes and light bulbs, all at prices you can really afford. For personal service and low prices, bring your family to the True Value family of stores.
It's the end of the week and you don't have your Lotto cash tickets for Saturday's $9 million jackpot? Why? Isn't $9 million all cash, all at once, enough to buy all the wonderful things you dream about? Isn't $9 million cash worth taking a shot at? Someone's going to win sometime, and it may as well be you. Get to a lottery retailer now and get your chance for $9 million by playing Lotto Cash for Saturday from the Hoosier Lottery, where you gotta play to win.
Back once again at Penn State University, Rick Hall. A very confined little establishment here, and Penn State takes advantage every moment of it, and it's 55-53, Indiana on top by just two with 8:47 to go.
We've had 1, 2, 3 ties in this half. We've had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lead changes. Indiana has hit 6 of its last 9 shots to get itself back into this thing. They're hitting 8 of 15 this half. But Penn State, which came into this game shooting only 42% on the season, is hitting 45% in this game, 22 of 49. They are 7 of 18 in this half. So they have found their eye tonight against Indiana, and the Hoosiers are struggling at the moment, but they do have a 2-point lead.
And it'll be Indiana basketball. The Hoosiers lead by 2. Todd Leary will inbound. Leary finds Damon Bailey with the pass back to Todd. Leary will bring it across the timeline. Indiana's been using a 3-guard offense for quite a while now. Here on the left side is Leary back outside to Graham. Now to Bailey for a 3, and he missed it. The rebound comes away to Penn State's John Amici. Now the pass to Michael Jennings, and Jennings will walk it up. Across the timeline, picks up the pace, drives it right wing. Holds, bounces out to Carlton, who fires a 16-footer, and he hit it. Rashawn Carlton has his 10th point of the game. All 10 have come in the second half here. He's 4 out of 5 from the field today. He's only a 45% shooter normally. 55 all time. Here is Chaney to Bailey to Leary. Top of the key. Todd drives it back left. Spins back right to Damon. Damon back out to Todd. Long 3-pointer. Way short. Rebound pulled out of there by Bailey. Man, he shot that from about 24 feet. That was an NBA 3. Indiana got the long rebound. Leary back to the left side of the wing. Looks, cross-courts it to Damon Bailey. Bailey in the corner to Calvert. He fakes. He drives. Bounces into Graham. It's stolen away. Now Rashawn Carlton for Penn State on the right wing. Gets it outside to Jennings. Jennings sets the offense. It's a 55-55 tie with 7:28 to go. Jennings, right wing dribble. Down low to Amici. Amici turns on Nover. Fakes. Fires it up. No, but a foul. Matt Nover will be called for his 4th foul. That's going to bring Allen Henderson back in the ballgame. Henderson scored Indiana's first 6 points of the second half and has 16 for the ballgame. He's played quite well tonight, both in the area of scoring and rebounding.
Well, Indiana's Calvert Chaney has really been kept out of the offense in this half. He's taken only 3 shots. He's hit 1. His rebounding has picked up, but they've really done a good job on Chaney in this half.
Well, the Nittany Lions could take the lead again. Deron Hay sits down. Greg Bartram is back in. John Amici goes to the free throw line with 10 points. He is 4 out of 5 from the stripe tonight. And now 5 out of 6. He's got 11. And the Nittany Lions again take the lead by 1. Amici will try to make it 2 with 7:19 to go. Second shot. Good again. 12 for Amici. And timeout is called. Indiana trails Penn State 57-55 with 7:19 left. Back after the 60-second network timeout.
Listen carefully. Hear anything wrong? Of course not. You see, the parts in this engine are Napa brand, backed by Napa's National Warranty Program. So if you bought a part in Boston and it didn't work in California, you could return it to one of the 6,700 Napa stores coast to coast. But don't worry, nothing ever goes wrong when you have a warranty. Napa, because there are no unimportant parts.
Say, neighbors, that one of those new snapper lawn tractors I see in your garage?
You betcha. This baby is built tough, and talk about power. A Briggs IC with 12 horses, Peerless 5-speed gear drive, 30-inch cutting deck with 6 cutting heights, 32-inch turning radius, 2-year limited warranty.
Boy, you must have run into some cash to buy this snapper tractor a couple of months before the grass needs to be cut.
Oh, not at all. I just use Snap Credit, so I don't have to start paying for it until October. Besides, with snapper tractors starting at $14.99, these babies aren't going to last very long down at the snapper dealer.
You know, neighbor, I think I'll go visit that snapper dealer before the spring rush starts.
Well, back once again at Penn State. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
WNJY Delphi Monticello, an affiliate of the Agra America Network. Listen for the latest Agra news every morning at 6:05 and in the noon hour.
Well, here at the Rec Hall, it is Indiana down two with 7:19 to go. Max, it has been anything but easy.
It certainly has. Allen Henderson, who had 10 rebounds in the first half, has gotten only 2 rebounds here in the second half. As we indicated, Cheney has picked it up a bit. He's gotten 3 rebounds here in the second half. He's got a total of 6. But the rebounding is being done by Amici right now with 8 rebounds as Penn State has out-rebounded Indiana in this half, 11-8.
Indiana will have the basketball. Todd Leary, Damon Bailey, Calvert Cheney, Allen Henderson, and Greg Graham, the Hoosier lineup right now. Bailey and Leary are playing the guard spots in the offense with Greg Graham as the third guard in there. On the floor for Penn State, and they're in his 2-3 zone are Jennings and Barkram at the guards, and Amici, Rashawn Carlton, and Eric Carr is back in as well at forward. Here's Graham to Leary. Back out to Graham. Graham on the dribble now. Starts it right, pulls up, looks for help, finally clears to Damon Bailey. Bailey now gives it right side to Leary on the wing. Back out to Damon. Damon goes left to Greg Graham. Back outside to Bailey. Bailey fires it out to Graham for a 3 try, and he buries it. Greg Graham with a big 3, his 11th point of the ball game. The Hoosiers retake the lead at 58-57. 6:41 to go. Across the timeline, Jennings to the right wing. Jennings takes it toward the baseline and fires a jump shot. Short rebound, Allen Henderson. Machi got away with a hole there. Here comes Leary the other way. Todd Leary to the right wing. Back outside on the dribble, still moving with it. Backs it out toward the midcourt line and starts it to the left side. Now Leary to the baseline, pulls it back out, looks for help, bounces to Damon Bailey. Bailey on the wing left. He brings it out to Greg Graham. Graham to Leary. Todd back to Calvert. Cheney fakes the 3, drives in. 16-footer is no good. Rebound knocked away at a foul call against Indiana. Allen Henderson gets nailed on the first one. That will be his third of the ball game. Nover has 4, Henderson has 3. 6:01 to go. Indiana by 1, 58-57. 18 foul committed by IU. The 1-1 in effect now for Penn State. And John Amici, who has been there a lot tonight at the stripe, is there one more time. He has hit 6 out of 7 from the free throw line. He has 12 points in the ball game.
Don, he's the only one that shot a free throw for Penn State tonight.
That is correct. He is the only one. He fires and misses, and the rebound comes off to Henderson, and Indiana with the lead and the basketball. Here's Bailey. Bailey looks at left side. Damon starts it to the right, comes back out to the left to Leary. Leary on the dribble to the wing to Greg Graham. Graham back to Damon. Damon down the right wing out to Calvert. Calvert pulls it back out to Leary. Down in the corner comes to Graham. 3 on the way. High off the rim, no. Henderson rebounds. Allen clears it back out to Bailey. Now outside to Leary. Indiana struggling with their shooting, but a big rebound there. Leary to Graham. Back to Bailey. Down to Leary, top of the key. To left to Greg Graham again. Into Calvert in the lane. He lost the handle, got it back, lost it again, and it's picked up by Penn State. Good defense by the Nittany Lions, and they got a chance to regain the lead. Here is Jennings the other way. Michael Jennings on the right side, flips it left and threw it away. Deron Hayes came up, or rather Eric Carr did, with a loose ball. Now Hayes on the right wing. Hayes looks in, gets it to Bartram, fires, and missed it. Rebound Amici, knocked away, out of bounds, Indiana ball. Oh, they overruled. Licklider overruled by Manji, and it'll be Penn State ball out of bounds.
That was a big call right there.
So Penn State's Bartram will inbound again. Bartram, a whistle, 5-second call. Bruce Parkhill is livid. He says, no way, 5 seconds evaporated that time. Licklider's telling Parkhill to sit down. Up the floor, Leary. Leary on the left wing. Fires to Greg Graham, out to Bailey for a 3. Good! Damon Bailey with a huge basket, his 8th point of the ball game. 61-57, IU by 4, 4:32 left. Here is Jennings on the right side dribble, and a reach-in foul is calling Greg Graham. Graham gets nailed for the personal. That will be Greg's 2nd of the ball game. Well, Greg Graham has hit one three-point fielder, a big one, and Damon Bailey's hit two in this half.
Well, I tell you, four of the last five baskets that Indiana's made have been three-point shots.
Yeah, Leary hit one, too. That's right.
They've really kept the ball out from underneath.
Jennings at the line, the first time tonight for anybody besides Amici, and he had one bounce off the back of the rim about 3 feet in the air and drop through. 17 for Michael Jennings, and he has reached his season high. One more, and he got it. He's got a new season high with 18 points. 61-59, Indiana's lead down to two at 4:26 to go. Here comes Leary. Leary goes to Graham to Bailey. Bailey directs some traffic, gives it back outside to Todd. Leary down on the left wing to Greg Graham. Graham back out to Todd Leary. Leary on the dribble toward the right, back to Bailey. Bailey looks inside, gets it to Calvert. Cheney turns around, clears back to Bailey for another three, and it's no good. Rebound pulled out of there by Eric Carr. Elton Carter, rather, with the board. Carter got the rebound, and Penn State with another chance to tie or go on top. Here is Jennings on the left wing. Jennings gets it outside to Deron Hayes for a 15-footer. That's the first two of the second half by Deron Hayes, and we're tied up at 61-all. 3:37 to go, and the Penn State fans are on their feet. Graham to Bailey to Henderson. His shot in the air, no good. And Bartram comes up with a rebound. Back the other way come the Nittany Lions. Here is Jennings on the right side dribble, outside to Hayes, left side to Carter. Carter on the dribble once, gets it back to Bartram. Bartram now fires it right. Off to Deron Hayes. Hayes looks low, bounces it away to Elton Carter. Carter now back out to Bartram. Bartram inside to Hayes, puts it up, and he got it. The 10th point of the game for Deron Hayes, and Penn State's on top again, 63-61. Leary to Graham to Bailey. Bailey to Calvert Cheney. He fakes, he drives, he fires, and he missed it, but there's a foul inside. It's against Elton Carter. Elton Carter has called for the foul, his fourth. The fans didn't like the call, but I think it was the right one based on what we saw here. And now timeout is called. The score, Penn State 63, Indiana 61. And Indiana will have the basketball when play resumes. We'll be back after the 60-second break. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
Have you ever thought about how much work your brakes do every day? You know, the average set of brakes stops your car safely over 100 times daily, and that's not counting when you slow down. Your safety, as well as the safety of your family, depends on your brakes. That's why Jim's Tune-Up take a great deal of pride in providing the very best in brake service. All brake jobs include a complete four-wheel check and turning of the drums or rotors if necessary. And you can even get pads that are guaranteed for as long as you own that car. See Jim's Tune-Up in Monticello today on First Street under the big smokestack.
If you've been waiting for the right carpet sale, wait no longer, because Carpetland has done it again. It's our four-day carpet sale, Sunday through Wednesday. 35 to 60% off of every carpet, every brand, and every style. Add to that 50 to 60% off of every remnant and every short roll. No interest for 6 months. If you are in the market for any type of floor covering, this sale cannot be missed. And it ends Wednesday, so shop now and save at Carpetland on State Road 26 East in Lafayette.
Call at University Park in State College, Pennsylvania. 2:42 to go, and the Hoosiers are in the throes of a major, major upset. They trail by two, and they hold the number one ranking in the country. They beat Penn State by 48 in the first meeting this year, but it is shades of deja vu here tonight from last season.
Well, the thing Indiana has to concern themselves about now is that Penn State has nine fouls. That means Penn State will shoot two every time there's a foul. Penn State has only five fouls, so Indiana's got a ways to go before they can go to the line. So Penn State very definitely the advantage here with a two-point lead.
Damon Bailey will inbound. Bailey lobs it into Calvert Cheney. He bounces it out to Greg Graham. Graham on the backcourt dribble. Gives it off to Todd Leary. Back to Graham. Right side to Bailey. Bailey pulls it back out of there. Gives it to Graham once again to Leary left side. Time on the wing. Looks it inside. Comes back to Graham. Graham fakes. Drives it left. Spins. Gives it to Bailey in backcourt. Bailey to the right wing. Back out against the zone to Leary. Now to Graham. Graham fires a three. He got it! Greg Graham with a huge basket, his 14th point of the game, his third three of the night, and Indiana leads by one. 64-63. Jennings, jump pass comes off left side to Elton Carter, outside to Greg Bartram. Bartram goes right off to Deron Hayes. Hayes on the dribble now, circles it in backcourt, gives it right side to Carter. Carter back out to Bartram. Bartram works and takes it to the left side. Bartram to Hayes on the left wing. Hayes turns around, looks for help, gives it out to Carter, right side to Bartram. Bartram, 10 seconds on the shot clock. Drives, spins, turns around, bounces it into Hayes. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Hayes baseline fadeaway shot off the rim. No, rebound, Calvert Chaney. Chaney clears the boards, a huge rebound, and here's Indiana on the attack with a point lead. 1:18 left. Bailey. Backcourt to Greg Graham. Graham backs it out. Gives to Bailey again. Bailey backs it near the midcourt line. Nobody guarding him. They're going to let the clock run down. We're about down to a minute. Inside a minute. Here's Bailey. Left side to Henderson. Shot clock at 12. Out to Greg Graham. Graham now. Indiana wants to get it going. Bob Knight says move it. Here's Calvert. Baseline drive. Chaney pulls it back out. Tried to force it up. It wouldn't go. It hit the backboard. They'll give it to Indiana. It was touched by a Penn State player. And Indiana will get the basketball. And Bob Knight says, do we get a new 45 out of that? Gene Mangi is saying, wait a second. We'll wait and see. There's only 2 seconds on the clock. On the shot clock. Here's Bailey. Lobs it into Henderson and a whistle. We got a foul call. Oh, they nailed it on Henderson. They call the foul on Allen Henderson with 41 seconds to go, and Penn State will go to the free throw line with a chance to take the lead back. And guess who? John Amici once again. Amici has hit 6 out of 8 in the ball game. 64-63, 41 seconds to go. And John Amici can tie it with his first free toss. They get 2 for every shot now. He gets 2 shots. Indiana's committed 10 team fouls. He hits the first. It's tied up. 13 for Amici. And it's 64-64 all with 41 seconds to go. Amici can give Penn State the lead. He eyes number 2. It's in the air. It is good. 14 for Amici, and timeout is called. It is 65-64, Penn State with 41 seconds to go. The Nittany Lions with a 1-point lead and 41 seconds from the upset of the season.
Well, boy, it would be the upset of the season. No one would have thought this game would have gone quite this far. I thought myself that Indiana was going to have a tough time out here because it was awfully tough coming off of that Iowa game on the road. They'd had some tough road games in which they had won. They've got Michigan coming up on Sunday, and I'm sure it was awfully, awfully hard to focus on this game. Penn State, on the other hand, facing the number one team in the country, had everything going for it, and what a ball game it has played. I think, Don, tonight, the thing that Penn State has done so well has shut off Indiana's inside game. Calvert Chaney has not had any kind of a shot at all here in the second half to mount anything. Henderson, most of his baskets have come from rebound shots. Everything has come from the outside, as Indiana has hit 1, 2, 3, 4 of their last pick at 5 of their last 6 baskets have come from the outside. And now Indiana has got to figure out what they want to do. They could hold the clock all the way down. It's under 45 seconds.
As you said, Calvert Chaney has scored just 2 second half points, 12 points in the first half, just a field goal in the second half. Indiana comes out of the floor with Henderson, Chaney, and listen to the crowd.
They are loving every second of this. Indiana's ball. Here comes Leary. Tom drives it right side. Fell down. Lost the ball. Here's Jennings on a breakaway, and he's fouled, and the shot goes in, and it will count. 31 seconds to go. Bob Knight wants a timeout. These fans are going absolutely crazy. Todd Leary slipped and fell down. Michael Jennings picked up the ball, ran down. Damon Bailey fouled him, but the shot thrown up went in anyway. And now it's a three-point ball game, 67-64, with 31 seconds to go.
Boy, you'd almost have to think that the home crowd tonight is doing everything. Even the floor is helping out. I've noticed Indiana slip a couple of times on this floor. I don't know what the problem down there, but they have slipped a couple of times. But no other slip was bigger than that one, because if he hits this free throw, that's a four-point lead with 31 seconds, and it's going to be awfully hard to get back from that.
Well, with a three-point lead, Penn State will have a chance to add a fourth point. Michael Jennings will go to the line. He has 20 points in this ball game. He will get a chance to add the insurance, and then Indiana must get at least two baskets to get back into it. If they get a couple of threes, of course, but it's a four-point ball game if he hits the free throw. 31 seconds to go, and Michael Jennings has 2 for 2 from the line tonight and 20 points, and by far his best game of the year scoring-wise. He has the ball in his hands. He shoots it in the air, and it is good. 21 points. Here come the Hoosiers. Greg Graham the other way. Takes it all the way, lays it up, and scores. Timeout is called with 24 seconds. It ain't over yet. Greg Graham just ran down the floor, got his 16th point, and now the Hoosiers will send in Chris Reynolds. 24.7 seconds to go, and Max, they didn't even guard him. He just went down the floor and weaved his way through traffic and went right to the hole for a very quick two. Indiana's not dead yet.
No, they're not done yet, but they've got to come up with a big steal. They don't want to foul anybody because they're going to get two shots if they do, and that would put them right back up at 4 points again. So they've got a hard rock to lean against once again, but nevertheless, they've got a chance yet with almost 25 seconds, actually 24.7, but they've got to do something quick as the ball comes in bounds. Boy, you can see how a tough place this is to play. Penn State plays very, very well in this place.
Well, they just play with super confidence here, Max. When we came up here tonight, they didn't even have the press area set up yet, but I watched when Penn State came out for their shoot-around here, and then in their initial warm-ups with layups and so on, they were out there having a slam dunk contest, so they knew they were loose as a goose, had nothing to lose, and everything to gain here in this ball game. And obviously, they played like it. The Hoosiers, on the other hand, have struggled with their shooting again tonight and have had problems hitting over that zone.
Well, Indiana's hit only 44% from the field tonight. They're hitting 35% from three-point range. Penn State, 46% tonight.
Here we go. Here is DeRon Hayes inbound. Having trouble. Throws it in, and it comes to Jennings. Two Indiana players hit the deck. DeRon Hayes, or rather Jennings, now lost the handle. Threw it out of bounds. It's going to belong to Penn State. Oh, my. 19 seconds left. We can't see here because the crowd keeps standing up in front of us. We'll try to pick it up as best we can. Inbound pass will come, and they call timeout. Timeout by DeRon Hayes. Indiana playing some very tough defense, and Allen Henderson guarding the ball in the inbounds play, and they couldn't get the pass in. 68-66. 19 seconds left. Penn State leads by 2. And the Hoosiers trying with everything they've got to get back into the ball game with a basket of some kind and a stop at the other end. Actually, a stop at the other end first, then a basket of some kind.
Well, even think back of this game of how many individual plays have amounted to things, like the three-point shot that Penn State hit at the end of the half that pulled them within two. Of course, the Leary slip will go down as the thing they write about, but there have been all kinds of plays through here today. Two missed layups in that first half, you may recall. Henderson missed one, I believe, and Leary again missed one. All of those things now are coming back to haunt Indiana in this game.
Well, it just seems like when Indiana just pounds somebody at home and they go on the road, the second meeting, they have their problems, at least this particular ball club. And, Max, it was so evident last year, and you thought, well, this ball club knows it. They know they're going to have a tough time tonight because Penn State's going to be ready. They come in here, and they struggle again.
Well, Penn State's only turned it over 11 times tonight, and that certainly has been a significant change from what they did in that first game. You recall in that game, they turned it over a total of 19 times. And here we go.
We'll again stand up to see what we can see. The inbound will come, I believe, from Elton Carter. Carter throws it in. Reynolds tried to steal it, and they're going to call a foul.
Oh, the foul is against Greg Bartram. They're going to say Bartram used the forearm to ward off Chris Reynolds, and the Hoosiers are going to get the basketball. Bartram will be called for the foul, and Indiana has got life. Bartram is called for the foul. His first of the ball game, and timeout is called by Indiana. So, the Hoosiers get a huge break as Bartram and Reynolds went down the floor, and as Chris Reynolds went up, Max, to try and intercept the pass, the official, Sam Licklider, says Bartram used his forearm to ward off Reynolds, and there was the foul. And Indiana will get the ball with 17 seconds to go.
Well, I tell you, that was a gutsy call on the part of Sam, because it was one of those fouls that probably could have been ignored, but here before the home crowd, he called it against the home team, and you don't normally get that kind of a call in a home team. The fans across the way now are pointing to the replays, I can see on the, as they're looking down the scores table. They don't agree, but nevertheless, that's the way the call is going to stay. Indiana does have a chance. 17 seconds, plenty of time, but they've got to make sure they get the points.
Well, what do? You look for the good shot, or you just come down the floor and try to get whatever you can to get a chance at knocking one down, and then, of course, if it doesn't go in, trying to get the rebound. But you can't waste time.
No, you can't wait a lot of time, but you've got to come down, set it up quickly, but you also would like not to give them any time to come back either if you can score.
Bailey, Chaney, Graham, Leary, and Reynolds, or Henderson, rather, the lineup for IU. Calvert, Chaney inbounds to Bailey. Bailey brings it up the floor. Not as quickly. Now he gets it across the timeline down to 12. 11. 10. Bailey still in back. Lost the handle. Got it back. 7. 6. Bailey turns. Gives it to Leary. Leary from three-point range to Greg Graham. A three is no good. A whistle and a foul. Hold on. Hold on. Greg Graham, I think, is going to be called for a foul. 3/10 of a second is all that's left. Wait a second. I think he's going to get three shots, Max.
I think so, too.
Greg Graham went up for a shot, and they call a foul. It'll be three shots coming to Graham. The foul was on Bartram. How about this for unbelievability? Greg Graham will get three shots. And timeout is called by Penn State. Absolutely incredible turn of events in this basketball game. Indiana first gets the break when Bartram is called for a foul, pushing off as a long pass down the floor. Gave the basketball back to Indiana on a foul that was committed by Bartram on Chris Reynolds. And then they come back the other way, get a three-point shot. It doesn't fall, but Greg Graham was knocked into the stands by Bartram. And Indiana will get three shots here. Greg Graham, who has been leading the Big Ten in free throw shooting with 91% coming into the ball game, will get a chance to go to the line. But tonight, Max, he's just 3 out of 5.
Well, he was second in the Big Ten through last week's games. He had hit 32 out of 35 coming into tonight's game in Big Ten play. That's 91.4%. But as you indicated, he had hit only 3 out of 5 tonight. And he has got 3 monumental free throws.
3/10 of a second is all that's left. So if he hits all of them, the game is virtually over with. The crowd comes to life once again. If he hits 2 of them, they're tied, and they'll go to overtime. Graham at the line, the senior out of Warren Central High School in Indianapolis. The first shot in the air, and it is no good. He missed it. Now he's got to hit them both. He has got to hit them both. The crowd again at its feet. Graham's second one in the air. He got it. Greg Graham hits the second shot, his 17th point. He gets one more crack at tying it. Greg Graham, eyes, flies, hits! Greg Graham hits the free one. It's tied up at 68. There's the ball game. It's tied and they'll go to overtime. Unbelievable. Graham hits the second and the third of 3 shots to give Indiana a chance here in overtime. Unbelievable. The regular finish score is 68-68. 2 incredible opportunities to Indiana. First, on a foul committed by Bartram, giving the ball back to IU. They run the clock down to about 7 seconds. Then they start their offense. Bailey almost lost the ball, Max. Somehow they got it to Graham in the corner here in front of us. He threw up a 3-point field goal attempt. Bartram apparently hit him. And 3 free throws coming to Greg Graham. He missed the first one and then sinks the second and the third to tie the ball game and send it into overtime.
Well, I had a good feeling when he hit that second one that he was going to hit the next one to tie it up. But, boy, what an opportunity would have been for Indiana to put it away. But what pressure it was on Greg Graham. Indiana's been in one overtime this year. They beat Florida State out in Madison Square Garden early in the season. So now they've got an opportunity to try to win their second.
Well, we have seen a lot of things happen in Indiana basketball history over the past 20 years. I'm not so sure we didn't see one of the more incredible endings to a regulation part of the game. That was simply incredible. Calvert Cheney and John Amici will jump it up. Here it is, the tip, controlled by Penn State. So Amici got the tip. And with the ball is Jennings right wing. Michael Jennings hooks the pass to Hayes. He sires a 16-footer and got it. Boy, I tell you what, they just won't go away. 12 for Deron Hayes, Penn State by 2. Indiana basketball, Reynolds to Bailey. Backcourt dribble gives it to Greg Graham. Now left side to Reynolds. In the corner to Henderson. Back to Reynolds. Back out to Bailey. Bailey now slides it out to Greg Graham, top of the key. Graham, left side to Reynolds. Back out to Graham. Graham turns around, gets it to Henderson, who clears to Bailey. Down low to Calvert. Baseline lost it, got it back, clears it again to Bailey. Now to Graham. Inside to Calvert. Turns, drives in, fires the shot up and couldn't get it. Rebound tipped up. It wouldn't go. Rebound Henderson. Back up he goes. Throws it up. No. The ball slung. Calvert Cheney saved it. Henderson comes up with it. Greg Graham fakes. 15-foot jump shot is no good. And the rebound to Deron, or to Michael Jennings of Penn State. Man, oh man, nothing is easy, is it? Down the floor. And we got a foul call. Chris Reynolds, I believe, nailed on it. Well, the foul's on Henderson. It was on that. It was on Allen Henderson, and he just fouled out of the ball game. So Henderson finishes with 16 points. Here comes Todd Leary in, along with Manover. Chris Reynolds will sit down. So Henderson fouls out, 3:46 left. Amici goes to the free throw line. 14 points for John Amici tonight. And he can start that build of the lead for Penn State here.
Henderson had 16 rebounds tonight.
Omeche hits it. 15 points now for Omeche. He can make it a four-point lead for Penn State. The Hoosiers have been climbing the mountain all night long. Omeche drills his second. He's got 16. It's a four-point Penn State lead. 72-68. Leary across the timeline. Todd starts it to the left side. Leary looks, gives to Graham. Now to Bailey. Damon slides it to the right wing. Back to Graham. Now to Leary. Leary in the corner to Nover. Matt back to Todd. Out to Graham. Graham holds, gives it back left to Leary for a three. He missed it. Rebound, Michael Jennings. Indiana can't buy the hoop tonight. They simply can't get the shots down. Here is Jennings on the right side dribble. Gives it off to Bartram on the right wing. Bartram fires it back outside to Carr. Now off to Jennings. Jennings holds, gives it off to Deron Hayes. A jump shot is good. Deron Hayes has got 14. It's now a six-point lead for Penn State. 2:55 to go. Leary left to Calvert. Chaney to Graham. To Leary. He fires another three. It's good. Todd Leary, a three-point bomb, his second basket of the game. It's a three-point contest. 74-71. 2:36 to go. Up the floor. Jennings. Right side move against Graham to the wing. Back he spins, gives it left to Hayes. Now out to Carr. Carr to Bartram. Right side to Hayes. Hayes looks it low. Back out it comes to Jennings. Jennings left side to Bartram. Down low to Omeche. Omeche turns on Nover. Omeche threw it up, a whistle. We got a foul call on Nover. And that's it for him. Ryan Evans will come in. So Indiana has lost both of its frontline big men, Matt Nover and Allen Henderson. Nover fouls out with 7 points. Henderson fouled out a few moments ago with 16. And John Omeche, who has been living at the line tonight for Penn State, is there again.
He's 10 for 12 tonight.
Brian Evans comes in to replace Omeche, or rather Nover, as Omeche will go to the line. Indiana leads, or rather trails by three with 2:14 to go. Omeche takes the deep breath. He'll get two. The first is no good. That one was off the back of the rim hard. 2:14 left. Man, oh man. What a ball game this has been. Up it goes. He got that one to roll in. 17 for Omeche. And now the lead's back to four. 2:12 left. Here comes Todd Leary. The zone put up by Penn State. It's been tough all night. Here's Graham. Graham to Leary. Leary back to Graham. Left side to Calvert. Calvert back to Graham. Top of the key. Greg looks in, bounces it away to Calvert. Calvert to Bailey. Damon takes it into the lane, gives it out to Greg Graham. Off to Calvert Chaney for a three try. He got it! Calvert Chaney scores a three, his 17th point of the game. 75-74. Penn State by one. 1:40 left. Now across the timeline, Hayes. Hayes in backcourt to the wing. Gives it outside to Jennings. Jennings holding against Graham. Drives it toward the right side. Spins back left. Bounces into Hayes. Hayes turns around at Evans. Hayes drives. Scoop shot good. Deron Hayes has got 16. He's got six in the overtime. Six of their eight. Now, Calvert. Back outside it comes to Graham, to Leary, to Bailey. Bailey. Back to Leary. Leary to Graham. Graham fakes inside. 1:04 to go, and the Hoosiers are down three. Calvert Chaney fakes. Pulls it back out. Gives it to Graham. Graham drives it back top of the key. Greg Graham goes to Calvert Chaney. Calvert on the dribble outside. Shot clock at 12. Here's Bailey for a three. He hit it! Damon Bailey scores a three, and we're tied up at 77 all. 11 points for Bailey, his third three of the night. Can you believe this? 33 seconds to go. A timeout, Penn State. Absolutely incredible. 77-77 with 31 seconds to go. Max, this will get your heart pounding if nothing else in the world will.
Well, it really is pounding, and it has been pounding for about the last 10 to 15 minutes. Indiana's three-point shots are the only thing that are keeping them in this basketball game. They've hit 1, 2, 3 in this timeout. They've hit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of them since the 11-minute mark. During that period, they've hit only two-point shots. So you can see that they are living dangerously by the three-point shot here in the second half. But they've been forced to do so because Penn State has been so effective with their defense that they have not given Indiana the opportunity to get underneath. And as a result, they've had to put it up from outside the rim. So far, they've hit enough of them to stay even in this game. But Penn State now can hold on to the basketball. They don't have to do anything but wait and take the last shot if they can do it. This time around, as opposed to the end of the basketball game, should Penn State miss and Indiana be fouled, they are in the 1-1 now, so they would be going to the line as opposed to what was happening right at the end of the game.
This is absolutely incredible. 77-77 tie with 31 seconds to go. Penn State will have the ball. Indiana has fought their way back up the hill again. Now, can they get a stop here and a chance to win it? The inbound to Amici. Off to Jennings. 27 seconds. Jennings to the right side. Jennings to the left. Bounces it off to Bartram. Bartram looked like he traveled, but apparently not. Off to Carter. Carter looks in right. 15 seconds to go to Jennings. Jennings circles left. Down to 12. Jennings on the left wing. Almost threw it out to Amici and threw it away. Amici, 7 seconds to go. Backs it out. Looks. Fakes. Looks. Turns. Fires the shot up. No good. Rebound battle for, and they're going to go to double overtime. They're going to go to double overtime. It is 77-77. John Amici holding on the ball, it seemed like forever out there, throws up a prayer just before the clock winds the double zeros. Bartram, Max, almost had a chance at a tip in there. But Indiana survives the first overtime, and they got another one coming up.
I also thought he had an opportunity to commit a foul there, but I don't think the official was up to making that kind of a call with no seconds left. But he did almost get a chance, and now Bob Knight's going to go over and say something to the officials. I don't know what he's talking about. But the problem Indiana faces now in this overtime is that they do not have either Henderson or Nover. So their rebounding is going to be affected. So it's going to be up to the young Brian Evans to come through and give some big rebounds in there along with Cheney and the rest of the players that are in there. And for the first time now, Indiana's nine-man squad is starting to show how much problems that can be when you don't have anybody sitting on the bench to come in and help out.
Well, I'm not sure about anybody else, but if I had any fingernails, they'd be gone right now. And I'm glad Dr. Larry Rink is along on the trip because he's a cardiologist and some of us might need him by the end of the night.
Well, I'm perfectly calm here. I haven't been able to write for the last couple of seconds, but, you know, what the heck.
I was going to say, can you read your writing now?
Nobody cares just yet.
Another five-minute overtime. It was 68-all at the end of regulation, 77-all at the end of the first overtime. And we got number two coming up. Calvert Cheney will jump it against the Amici. And this time it is Indiana controlling. Brian Evans tips it out to Greg Graham. Graham stops in backcourt. Bounces to Calvert. Cheney looks it inside. Now a man defense. Here's Calvert driving. Scores! Big hoop for Indiana. Calvert Cheney's 19th point. 79-77. Penn State's Michael Jennings crosses the timeline. Takes it right side. Jennings on the wing, still in the dribble. Fires in the corner. It comes to Bartram, who gets it off to Hayes. Hayes on the baseline right against Bailey. Brings it out to the wing. Down low to Amici. Amici against Evans. Puts it up. Got it. Amici scores his 19th point of the game. It is 79-79. 4:14 to go. Here's Todd Leary. Leary, now they're back to the zone. To get Calvert Cheney to Bailey. Back out to Calvert. To Greg Graham. Graham off to Leary. Leary spins, gives it out to Calvert. Left side to Bailey. Three on the way. He missed it. Rebound inside. Pulled out of there by Jennings. 3:54 left. 79-79 tie. Here's Jennings. Lost the handle. Almost fell. And Greg Graham's going to be called for a foul. Greg Graham tried to reach around that time and pull the ball out of there. Picks up foul number three. And it's going to put two shots coming to, it looks like, Michael Jennings, who will go to the free throw line for Penn State. Rashawn Carlton now will come in, and Bartram will go to the sideline.
Well, Jennings has hit all three foul shots he's taken. He's been hitting 76% of his shots here in Big Ten play, 67 on the season.
Both Henderson and Nover fouled out in the first overtime for Indiana. Jennings of the stripe has 21, a season high. And he misses. He missed that free throw. He'll have one more shot coming. He can give Penn State a one-point lead if he converts here. 3:44 left. Jennings puts it in the air, and it is no good. He missed them both. Rebound, Brian Evans. Evans clears to Greg Graham. The Hoosiers can retake the lead. Graham to Leary. Todd on the dribble right. Back out to Brian Evans. Evans fakes, gives it off to Calvert. Chaney back to Leary. Leary in backcourt. Leary now gets it right to Bailey. Bailey back out to Todd. Todd left to Graham. Down to the corner to Calvert. Three on the way. High off the rim, no. Rebound pulled out of there by Rashawn Carlton. Penn State with the ball again. 79-79 tie, 3:05 to go. Right side pass goes to Hayes. Hayes down low to Rashawn Carlton, and a whistle and a foul on Bailey. And Bailey now has four. The fourth foul on Damon Bailey. So again, free throws coming to Penn State. This time it's Rashawn Carlton. He has 10 points. He's a 62% free throw shooter on the season. He's shot no free throws so far tonight, and he'll have two chances here. Weidman comes into the game. Michael Jennings sits down now for Penn State. So Rashawn Carlton averaging just 4-8 a ball game, 6-5, however, in Big Ten play, and 10 points tonight, hits it. He's got 11. Carlton now with 11, and it's 80-79, Penn State by one. 3:01 to go, and Carlton has one more coming to make it a two-point lead if he converts. And he does. 12 points now for Carlton. 81-79. Indiana down two with 3 minutes to go. Graham to Leary. Backcourt to Bailey. A man-to-man being used. Nope, it's back to the zone. Now, Graham into Brian Evans. Back out to Leary. Leary fakes, clears it outside. It comes off. Bailey has it. Off to Calvert. Chaney to Bailey. Bailey left to Brian Evans. Evans back to Bailey. Top of the key. Shot clock at 19. Plenty of time. Calvert. Left side to Leary. Back to Calvert. Now to Bailey. Shot clock at 10. Now the pass in the corner to Calvert. Calvert drives in the lane. Fires up a shot. It is no good. Rebound pulled out of there by Penn State. 2:17 left. Two-point Nittany Lion lead, and Weidman with the basketball. Weidman crosses the timeline to the right side on the wing. Bounce pass in the corner, almost taken away. Hayes comes up with it. Back out it comes to Carr, now to Weidman. Weidman on the wing, backs it out. Weidman bounces it away to Hayes. 1:55 left. Outside to Carr. Now right side to Weidman. Weidman back out to Carlton. A long jump shot, short. Rebound, battle for, knocked out. Penn State will come up with it. 1:42 to go. Again, the clock becomes a major factor. Weidman bounces to Hayes on the right wing. Hayes into Carlton. Down low. Oh, he got in. Rashawn Carlton with an unbelievable shot. His 14th point. It's a four-point Penn State lead again. 1:23 to go. Calvert outside to Bailey. Back to Calvert. He fires a three. He got it. Calvert Chaney with his 22nd point of the game. Incredible. And timeout is called by Indiana. The Hoosiers are down 183-82 with a minute and 12 seconds to go. Unbelievable basketball. Every time it looks like Indiana's down and out, Max, somehow they fight their way back up.
Well, they've still got a way to go, but they're a little bit closer right now than they were about 20 seconds ago when they were down by four. They have trailed in the first timeout. They trailed by as much as 6 points here in this second one. They've been down by four. And, of course, at the end of the game with only 24 seconds to go, make that 31 seconds to go, they were down by four in that game. So they have been down by more points than you care to think about and have somehow gotten themselves back even, but now they've still got that problem again. And of course, now we've got to worry about fouls out there. Damon Bailey with four fouls. Greg Graham has three right now. So only Bailey has a problem, as both Nover and Henderson have both fouled out. And of course, the remaining player that's left on the bench now is Pat Knight, who has not seen any action yet tonight. Chris Reynolds is also available to come in at guard play.
Well, we have seen a phenomenal ball game here tonight, no matter what happens. But, of course, Indiana trying to avert the upset. And Penn State trying to pull a miracle. And they have come close already in regulation and in the first overtime. But what a great effort Indiana's had in coming back. Chris Reynolds is back in there defensively for IU now. 1:12 to go. The inbound will come from Hayes. He gets it in. It's almost stolen away. A whistle. A foul on Brian Evans. Brian Evans is called for a foul on the inbound pass. Now they have let 4 or 5 seconds tick off that clock, Max.
Yeah, they're talking. They're going to have to put some back on.
The clock's down to 107. There was 112. And they just barely got the ball in bounds when the foul was committed. Definitely got to put some time back in the clock. They're not doing it. Not yet. Gene Mangi over there still talking to him. Bob Knight is saying, what in the world is going on? He's at the midcourt line. Knight's going back toward the bench now. Mangi and Crispin are conferring out there. 5 seconds ticked off the clock, and Max, there was no more than a second before the whistle blew when the pass was inbounded.
It can't be more than 2 or 3 seconds at the absolute most.
They're still talking. Knight's out there on the floor behind the official Dan Crispin talking. But, and of course the fans are all over them, but it's making little difference. Now let's wait and see.
They're not going to change it, boy, I tell you. Well, you got a little of a homer there.
Well, they're still conferring.
Well, maybe there's still a chance. There we go, Mel. It looks like they're going to change something here.
Yeah, they are going to change something. They just put 11-12 on the clock, so I don't think we got 11 minutes to go.
Now we go.
Now it's down to, it's 1-12. So they didn't let anything come off the clock. They put 1-12 back up there. Amici's at the line. He fires it up, no good. Amici missing. And he has been camped there tonight. So it can only be a 2-point lead if he hits this one. And he missed it. And Brian Evans has got the rebound. Evans did a nice job of avoiding the walk. And the Penn State fans wanted the call, but he did not walk. Here's Reynolds. Right side dribble. Back out it comes. Gets it into Calvert. Puts it up. It scores! Calvert Chaney with his 24th point of the ball game. Indiana by one. 84-83. 50 seconds to go. Right side dribble, Michael Jennings. Jennings spins in backcourt, looks inside. Having trouble, gets it to Amici. Amici outside. He fires it right, almost stolen away, and a foul on Greg Graham. And that's four on Graham. We're down to 36 seconds to go. Graham has called for his fourth foul. That means Bailey and Graham now both have four. And at the line will be Michael Jennings. Jennings missed his last two after hitting 3 for 3 in the first portions of this ball game. He has 21 points. And now he goes to the line. He fires this one up, and it is in. He got it to roll in. I want to tell you, that ball was short all the way. It hit the front of the rim and somehow gripped the rim and rolled through. He can untie it, and give Penn State a one-point lead if he hits. It's in the air. It is no good, and Brian Evans has got the rebound. Tie ball game at 84-84, and it's 30 seconds to go with Indiana on possession. Indiana wants one shot. Man-to-man defense again by Penn State. Gray Graham, 23 seconds. Graham, better move. Gets it to Reynolds. Reynolds with 15 seconds. Chris drives it left. Pulls it back out to Bailey. Left side to Evans. Brian Evans baseline. Fires the shot up. Oh, he hit it! Brian Evans hit it! 5 seconds to go. Timeout is called. What a shot by Brian Evans, the freshman from Terre Haute, and the Hoosiers lead by two. Absolutely incredible. Brian Evans' first 2 points of the ball game. What a pressure-packed field goal, and Indiana has 5.2 seconds to defend, and if they can get a stop now, they'll win it.
The only thing I would hope for, that Brian would have waited just a little bit longer. 5 seconds is a lot of time. Indiana has got to really play some tough defense here in order to avoid getting a shot away. Now the Knight wants to talk to the officials about something. I don't know what he's got planned here.
He waited as long as I wanted him to wait. It's his first two of the night, Max. That's two halves and two overtimes.
That is true, except you got to remember the score at that point was tied, so it was not a case of you want to get it away, but it would have been a lot better to have about 2 seconds, but nevertheless, we'll take it. Don't get me wrong. I'll take it. But I was kind of hoping maybe they go to somebody like Cheney. He'd also get fouled instead of putting up that little 10-footer out at the side that he did. But that's neither here nor there. Indiana's got to play tough defense now.
Well, I wonder now what Bob Knight decides to do. Here's the situation. 5.2 seconds left. Indiana leads by 286-84. Penn State takes the basketball out of bounds underneath the Hoosier hoop. That means they've got to go the length of the floor. Does Indiana foul? I doubt it. Bob Knight's never liked to do that. And, of course, they've got to hit a giant three here to win. Now time is called.
Bob wanted to take a look at the offensive setup that Penn State was going to use, and now he's going to come back again. Of course, Penn State will probably change theirs again now.
So Indiana, a two-point leader with 5.2 seconds to go in this basketball game, has somehow survived and now has the chance to win it as long as they can keep Penn State from converting any kind of a long jump shot, or if they do foul, a pair of free throws.
Well, Penn State, which was hitting free throws like you wouldn't believe early in the game, has missed 1, 2, 3 in this half, or in this overtime period, that has been very, very costly to them. Amici has missed a couple. Jennings actually has missed 3, so they've missed 5 free throws here in this overtime period, and that has really cost them. Indiana really has not gone to the foul line at all in either of the 2 overtime periods. And so as a result, the Penn State Nittany Lions have had numerous opportunities to put this thing away, as they've had some 4 and 5 and 6 point leads, but each time, as you described it, Don, Indiana has climbed the mountain, and we're out here in mountain territory, and they've been able to survive, and here we go again.
Well, it is double overtime, and Indiana with 5.2 seconds to go, trying to stop Penn State from scoring here. 86-84, Indiana on top by 2. Bartram will inbound. Bartram rolls down the baseline, throws a baseball pass up court. It is knocked away by Damon Bailey. Bailey picks it up. Indiana's going to win it. 1.4 seconds to go. They call the foul, and Bailey will go to the line. Penn State, I think, Max, tried almost an impossible play there.
They had 5 seconds. They could have brought it down the court in 5 seconds. That was an unbelievable play. I think that one's going to cost them dearly, as Damon Bailey now 1-1 with 1.4 seconds to go.
There is no question about that. I am shocked by that play. Bailey will go to the line. Bailey can absolutely salt it away with a 1-1. If he converts both, he checks the eyes of the rim, and his shot is up and in. Damon Bailey makes it now possible for Penn State, unless they hit a 3 and a foul, to win. Bailey has got 12 points in the ball game. He can sew it up with this one. Deep breath.
He eyes, he flies, he hits. Damon Bailey sews it up. Indiana will win it in double overtime. Here's the pass into Jennings, the half-court shot, and it does not go, and Indiana wins it 88-84. An incredible ball game and an incredible win for Indiana in double overtime. Bob Knight shakes hands with Bruce Parkhill. The players now out on the floor. The fans also out there surrounding all of the players. What a basketball game here at University Park, State College, Pennsylvania. Indiana 88, Penn State 84, and the Hoosiers leave with an unbeaten Big Ten record of 10-0, and they do it in incredible fashion. We'll be back to recap this ball game after we pause. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network, and this is a network timeout.
The game's heating up, Bob. Look at that.
I don't believe it, Bob.
The coach is bringing in
a Canon NP6060 from Copyright.
A Canon NP6060, Bob?
The copier that shoots a copy a second.
Holds 6,100 sheets of paper.
And has Copyright's exclusive total lifetime coverage.
With service in 4 hours or they pay you.
And a lifetime money-back guarantee.
No wonder Copyright's Indiana's biggest.
Copyright, the smart choice.
That's the Canon NP6060.
From Copyright.
Put it on your office team.
Call Copyright.
And do it today,
if not sooner.
University Broadcasting Company is proud to bring you IU basketball. University Broadcasting serves Indiana with the finest in sports radio. University Broadcasting Company operates two sports networks and seven radio stations, including WHHH, Hoosier 96 in Indianapolis, WBWB, B97 in Bloomington, WGCT in Ellettsville, and WAZY, Z96 in Lafayette. University Broadcasting Company is Indiana's radio broadcasting company. Thanks for listening.
Well, back once again at State College, Pennsylvania, the Rec Hall here on University Park on the campus of Penn State University. An incredible victory tonight for the Indiana Hoosiers. They survived double overtime against ninth place Penn State. The final is Indiana 88, Penn State 84. An incredible basketball game here this evening as this crowd files out a buzz. The Hoosiers survive double overtime, and believe me, I don't think survive is quite the term. They actually had to do an amazing comeback in both the first and second overtimes as well as regulation to win this ball game this evening. Indiana somehow found a way. That is the mark of a championship team. The final was 88-84 in two overtimes. Let's look at the individual scoring. First of all, for Penn State, Michael Jennings, a career high, 22 points tonight. Actually, that's a season high, but I believe a career as well. We'll check that momentarily. 19 for John Amici. 14 points for Rashawn Carlton. That also is a season high. 14 for Carlton. Then they drop down to Greg Bartram, who had 9. 2 points for Eric Carr. 2 points for Elton Carter. And playing but not scoring, Michael Joseph and Steve Weidman. So, four players in double figures. Michael Jennings, 22, 19 for John Amici, 14 for Rashawn Carlton, and 16 for Deron Hayes for Penn State here this evening. For Indiana, Calvert Chaney led Indiana once again, but was held to just 2 points in the second half, and then caught fire in the overtime with a pair of threes plus a pair of regular field goals. He finishes to lead Indiana with 24 points. Greg Graham also came up with some big plays in the game. He had 18. Alan Henderson, who played well in the first half and the early portion of the second half, had 16, but he fouled out in the first overtime, as did Matt Nover, who had 7. Damon Bailey finishes with 13, and he and Greg Graham both played the last few minutes of this contest with 4 personal fouls. Todd Leary had 6. Brian Evans had 2, and 2 for Chris Reynolds. So everybody that played tonight for Indiana was able to score in this ball game, and Brian Evans hit the key shot in this ball game to put Indiana up 86-84 with about 5 seconds to go in the ball game. And what an incredible play that was, his only bucket of the night. So the freshman from Terre Haute burns Penn State here this evening, and Indiana wins it by a final of 88-84 in double overtime. We'll be back to recap the team statistics in a moment, but first, let's pause for the 60-second
Timeout. This is the Indiana University Basketball Network.
I stopped in a muffler shop the other day to see about their so-called guaranteed muffler service. What I saw was this guy offering me the same muffler he had just put on a 1959 Packard. Come on. Not all cars are the same, and neither are their muffler systems. A muffler and exhaust system is an important part of your car's performance. At Jim's Tune-Up Center, their muffler service might cost you a little more, but when you leave, you're going to have a big A muffler designed especially for your car or light truck, and it's going to be warrantied for as long as you own that car. That's Jim's Tune-Up Center in Monticello on First Street under the big smokestack.
If you've been waiting for the right carpet sale, wait no longer, because Carpetland has done it again. It's our four-day carpet sale, Sunday through Wednesday. 35 to 60% off of every carpet, every brand, and every style. Add to that 50 to 60% off of every remnant and every short roll. No interest for 6 months. If you are in the market for any type of floor covering, this sale cannot be missed. And it ends Wednesday, so shop now and save at Carpetland on State Road 26 East in Lafayette.
Pennsylvania, Rec Hall, final score, Indiana 88, Penn State 84, in a thrilling basketball game here tonight, much more thrilling than I had hoped for. Nevertheless, a double overtime victory for Indiana, 88-84. Max, a quick look at the team stats in tonight's ball game.
All right, Don, for the game, it's Indiana shooting 34 of 76, that's 44.7, and that again makes another time that Indiana has fallen under the 50% mark. It's their fourth consecutive one. Penn State, on the other hand, hit 31 of 64, 48%, so they percentage-wise outshot the Hoosiers. It was the three-point shot that kept Indiana in the ballgame as they hit 10 out of 24 for 45%, while Penn State hit 5 of 12 for 68%. From the free throw line, Penn State won that battle, hitting on 17 of 25, while Indiana took only 14, but they hit on 10, and certainly those last two by Damon Bailey were the big ones. Rebounding, Indiana with 39 rebounds compared to 38 for Penn State, 13 turnovers for Penn State, and 12 for Indiana. And I do not have a breakdown on the halves and the other things, as things got hectic, and our statistician took off sometime during the second timeout, so I have no way to know what we did in the second half. But I do know individually tonight, Calvert Cheney finished 11 of 22. He was 6 of 10 in the first half, but only 1 of 6 in the second half. In the first overtime, 1 of 2 and 3 and 4 of the second half. Allen Henderson, who fouled out with 3 minutes and 46 seconds to be played in the first overtime, finished with 7 of 13. He was 4 of 8 in the first half, 3 of 5 in the second. Matt Nover, who fouled out with 2:14 to be played in the overtime, was 3 of 6 tonight, 2 of 5 in the first half, hit his only shot in the second half. Greg Graham finished the night 5 of 11, 1 of 3 in the first half, 4 of 8 in the second half. Damon Bailey was 4 of 11, 1 of 4 in the first half, 2 of 5 in the second half, 1 of 1 in the overtime, a three-pointer, and 0 for 1 in the second overtime. Chris Reynolds took one shot, he hit it. Todd Leary was 0 for 1 in the first half. He was 1 for 2 in the second half, and he was 1 for 2 in the second overtime. Make that the first overtime. And Brian Evans hit his big, big shot coming in the overtime. He had missed one in the first half, so he finishes the night 1 for 2. But it was some great foul shooting on the part of Amici that really kept things in, but his field goal shooting also was 4 out of 8. Deron Hayes really got started in the overtime. He had all three shots that he took in that second overtime period, but it was not enough. Michael Jackson, or Jennings, I should say, was the one that was really hot early on, as he hit 5 of 6 in the first half. He hit 3 out of 6 in the second half, but did nothing after that. Bartram was good early on, hitting 4 out of his first shots, but he was 0 for 3 in the second half. But Rashad Carlton is the guy who was setting things on fire in the second half. He hit all five shots that he took in the second half, but he hit only 1 out of 2 in the second overtime. And it was foul shooting that had given Penn State such a great advantage, cost them, as they missed 5 free throws in the second overtime, and that did them in. Indiana, at the half, was up by a 34-2 margin, the largest lead for Penn State, was a 6-point lead. It came at 74-68 in the first overtime. In the first half, they had led by 5. Indiana had 3 or 4 7-point leads in the first half, the last coming with 1 minute and 22 seconds to be played in the half, but Penn State came back and got it within 2. And then Penn State went on a run that built up a 5-point lead at 43-38. Then the ball game started getting close, and there were lots of lead changes from the 11-minute mark down to about the 41-second mark. Indiana was down by 4 with 31 seconds to go. Greg Graham had a chance to win it for him with 0.3 seconds when he was fouled on a 3-point shot. He missed the first, but he did hit the second 2 to tie it. And then in the overtime, Indiana quickly fell behind by 6, but they hit 3 3-point shots that got the game tied. And for the second overtime, then they dropped back by 4 again, but again a 3-point shot got them within 1, a 2-point shot gave them the lead, and then a basket by Brian Evans with 5 seconds to be played gave them a 2-point lead. And on an inbound pass that was certainly suspect, I would think, why you would try to throw it the length of the court with 5 seconds to be played, Damon Bailey stole the ball, he was fouled, he hit 2 free throws with a second and 4/10 left. And that was it. 88-84, the Hoosiers win another huge one on the road. And I'm sure that mentally and every other way, they will be ready for the Michigan Wolverines come Sunday.
Well, no matter what the case, survival is the name of the game in this league. And somehow Indiana found a way to do it tonight. Last year, on 2 separate occasions and 2 different ball games, just exactly like this one tonight, Indiana lost in ball games to Purdue and Minnesota. But tonight, despite Indiana winning by 48 at home, knew they would be in for a dogfight here at Penn State. The Nittany Lions gave them all they wanted, but somehow the Hoosiers survived, and they win it in double overtime, 88-84. This ball game tonight has been brought to you in part by Indiana Gas. For efficiency, comfort, and a cleaner environment, natural gas is your best energy value season after season. By your local Napa Auto Parts store. Napa, because there are no unimportant parts. By your local Amoco Certicare Repair Centers. By the Hoosier Lottery, where you've got to play to win. By State Farm Insurance and the more than 500 State Farm agents throughout Indiana. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By the real estate professionals at the 121 Century 21 offices in Indiana. By True Value Hardware. Got a tough job? You can do it with True Value Hardware stores. By Squadron Herbicide for a higher level of soybean weed control. And by Indiana's Rural Electric Cooperatives, consumer-owned for service excellence. Our special thanks to our studio producer, Gary Klein, to our statistician, Greg Elkin, or at least part-time statistician. And now this is Don Fischer for Max Skirvin, inviting you to stay tuned next for the IU postgame show. We'll be rejoining you in just a couple of minutes. So long, everybody.
Exciting Indiana University basketball on the area sports leader, WNJY, Joy 103. Today's game is sponsored by Pepsi Cola and your local Pepsi Cola bottler. Pepsi Cola, gotta have it. And by Jim's Tune-Up Center on 1st Street in Monticello behind Hooks. WNJY Joy 103 is connecting on three-pointers all the time with a full slate of college basketball broadcasts and Carroll and White County high school games, too, as called by the award-winning Joy 103 sports team. Sports is always presented professionally here on WNJY Joy 103. Why go anywhere else?
Smart. Let 1993 bring you something free. At Budget Car and Truck Rental, after you rent any car or van 5 times, you get a free day rental on an economy through full-size car. Budget provides you with a personalized frequent renter card to use every time you rent. It's good at all Budget Rent-A-Car of Central Indiana locations. So, when you need an economy car, mid-size car, full-size car, luxury car, minivan with unlimited mileage and special daily, weekly, and weekend rates, call Budget. Be smart. Start off 1993 with a guarantee of something free. Call now and reserve a new Buick Regal custom sedan with power windows and cassette, a sporty Pontiac Grand Prix, or a spacious Pontiac Transport SE minivan, and you'll be on the road to your free day rental. Whether for business or pleasure, the more you rent, the more free days you get. Budget Car and Truck Rental, located at 3305 South Street and at the Purdue Airport in Lafayette. Call today, 743-3987. That's 743-3987. Budget, where you get the best deals on wheels.
If you've been waiting for the right carpet sale, wait no longer because Carpetland has done it again. It's our four-day carpet sale Sunday through Wednesday. 35 to 60% off of every carpet, every brand, and every style. Add to that 50 to 60% off of every remnant and every short roll. No interest for 6 months. If you are in the market for any type of floor covering, this sale cannot be missed. And it ends Wednesday, so shop now and save at Carpetland on State Road 26 East in Lafayette.
Imagine the convenience of having a product that offers you the benefit of receiving your personal messages while you're shopping, driving, dining, or wherever you go. The Bravo Plus at Lafayette Telepage is that product. Be it an emergency or just a routine communication, the Bravo Plus from Lafayette Telepage is your indispensable communications link. What does the plus mean? It means an increase in battery life over 300%, message timestamping, PC-based programming, and over 20 other improvements. The Bravo Plus at Lafayette Telepage. Call in today at 423-4100 and ask him just how easy it is to be in touch.
Once again, this is Don Fischer and Max Skirvin with the IU Postgame Show. A review of tonight's ball game in which Indiana wins 88-84 over Penn State in double overtime this evening here at State College of Pennsylvania, I believe it is. And, you know, absolutely incredible. Norm Ellenberger is our postgame guest as always. Norm, I'm going to let you do all the talking because I've run out of breath.
Where are we?
State College, University Park, Rec Hall, Penn State University.
Okay, I'm along about 9:30 tonight. I put a towel over my head, and I missed the last 45 minutes of my life have been in a dark room. So if you've got a tape, let's just play the tape over.
We got a tape, but I'm not sure we got time to play it. That's the problem. What an incredible turn of events in this ball game. And I said at one point during the game, this team had to fight its way up the mountain a number of times tonight. They just kept getting knocked down, and somehow they managed to do it, and that's what title ball clubs do.
Well, goes back a little deja vu there. You know, we lost the same type of game last year against Purdue, and we lost the same kind of game last year against Minnesota after waxing them at home pretty good and then going on the road and laying a big fat egg, and we got a little bit of that tonight. You know, we didn't come out. You know, we had 7-point leads two or three times, maybe even more than that in the first half, and then wasn't tough enough and strong enough to go get command of the game by halftime. And they go into halftime after hitting a shot there that gives them great momentum, you know, and what that momentum brought them out, and I think they scored the first 5 or 6 points anyhow. Right. You know, so we're not playing, you know, we're not playing like we need to play. We went back to our old personality. Then on the other hand, you know, we're playing a pretty good team. We're playing a team that is really improving. You know, you could see last week on that game on the tube where they were playing Ohio State.
Right.
You know, they did everything but win that ball game after being ahead, you know, maybe it's 15-17 at times. So, and gee, did they shoot. Anytime they needed a shot, boy, they stuck one in. So, you know, a combination of all those things, that's kind of why I hid my head that last 45 minutes.
All right, we'll be back with more with Norm Ellenberger in a moment, but first let's pause for the 60-second timeout.
Let's talk electricity. I have a few words. Indiana's consumer-owned rural electric cooperatives. Quite a mouthful, huh? Well, maybe our name's so long because we do so much, like providing reliable electric service to over 1 million people across the state, or investing over $2 billion into bringing you the electricity that offers you necessities like lights, refrigerators, washers and dryers, and much more. Indiana's Rural Electric Cooperatives. But you don't need to call us by name. Just know we'll be there whenever you need us.
University Broadcasting Company is proud to bring you IU Basketball. University Broadcasting serves Indiana with the finest in sports radio. University Broadcasting Company operates 2 sports networks and 7 radio stations, including WHHH, Hoosier 96 in Indianapolis, WBWB, B97 in Bloomington, WGCT in Ellettsville, and WAZY, Z96 in Lafayette. University Broadcasting Company is Indiana's radio broadcasting company. Thanks for listening.
Back once again, Penn State University, Indiana in double overtime tonight, survives Penn State, 88-84 is the final. Norm Ellenberger, of course, our guest in the post game. Norm, let's talk just a little bit. We've already mentioned this is a tough ball game for Indiana to really get into tonight. And I know that Coach challenged these guys coming in here through the walkthrough this afternoon. He talked about the fact that you guys have got to come out here. I want to see this be a game that we can talk about for some years to come from the standpoint of how you attack Penn State.
Yeah, our our boss had a little feeling, he had a little inkling of this. I think maybe being gun-shy from coaching these guys now for 4 years, because we've seen them do this before. And but then again, you know, as soon as you talk about that too much, then you detract from what a great, great thing, Penn State did. You know, so we didn't play the best ball game that we could play. Penn State really, really played a whale of a ball game.
Well, the Associated Press guy next to me here said this is the best he saw Penn State play in 3 years.
Yeah, well, you know, welcome to the Big Ten. You know, they're a bona fide Big Ten team now after this. You know, I was just thinking here during the break, you know, one of the big, you know, there's a lot of really big plays, but we're down four, I think it was four, and we have a timeout, and we got the ball out on the other end of the court, and like maybe 30 seconds to go in the game, and coach says, get the ball in to either Damon or Greg, and go lay it in on the other end. You know, and he says, because, yeah, and he says, they're not going to foul you. And just go lay the thing in. And, ball got to Greg, and, you know, he looked like a fullback right over left guard. He just put his head down and put his head down like a bullet and laid it in on the other end. And that took, however long it took him to, 6 seconds. Now we're back into where we got a shot. That gave us a chance right there.
Certainly big three-point baskets by a whole bunch of people when they had to be had.
Well, we need a can opener to crack that zone that they had. Geez, they had a nice zone, and it got us to standing. And then they would shift to a man-to-man, and when, you know, it really threw us off. It's a little bit like Iowa played us. You know, Iowa played us real tough, changing from a man to a zone and back and forth again. And we had to go to the outside. Somebody had to make some shots because we got Nova on the bench, and then pretty soon we've got Henderson on the bench. We don't have any inside folks around, and then they kind of all took turns. I think everybody, all of our perimeter people, hit one in there, which we had to have, or we go home beat up really bad.
Norm, you talked about that zone, and that zone really was effective. It was particularly effective the way they took care of Cheney. They really kept him out of things there in the second half offensively.
Well, every time he catched it, he'd get two people on him, and he couldn't get the ball on the floor to go make a move. They really crowded him, it was a tremendous zone. They had and then we didn't penetrate well with the rest of the guys. You play that way on the road. You know, you get into this place, Max, this is something else. You know, the floor is real skinny. They got everybody right down on the court, and this is a tough place to play. And they put all the crazies over on one side over here. Gee whiz, boy, the blue jeans and combat boots. You know, that's what everybody has on around here. And those are just the girls. No, not really. I mean, they were really really great, great fans. You know, it's neat to come into a place where the students are the majority of the fans, because they really put a lot of atmosphere into the ball game.
Of course, they were in a situation where they had everything to gain, nothing to lose. They had the number one team they were playing against, Indiana. I'm sure Coach Knight was doing everything he could to prevent this, but I suspect that players were peaking a little bit at Michigan.
Well, you can look at that, but we about got our peak knocked right out of us. it'll be a long ride home, and we got 4 long days before we have to play again. We got to get this ship back on the right keel.
Obviously, Brian Evans' shot there at the end was just huge.
Brian hasn't made that shot. You know, he's people are now, you know, the book's out on Brian. He'll drill that three-pointer on you, and so they're starting to crowd him. So he gets the shot fake and gets into a little short drive and has that shot. He missed one in the first half. You know, like he threw up a real brick but this one went down, and it was really sweet. You know, and that you got to give him credit. I don't know where that one came from, because I had right in line on him. I thought, oh boy, because we've been working on him to pull up and shoot that little shot, I don't know whether he'll make the next one or not, but I'm sure he's glad he got the last one.
Norm, I hope that Larry Rink's going home with us. I need that cardiologist on my plane, but if he's not, you're welcome to him.
Okay, well, it's tough, but we got to win, like you kind of related to earlier. You know, you got to win a game like this now and then, and especially on the road, it makes it tougher, and maybe that'll let's just use it as a positive way and be thankful that we got out of here alive.
Congratulations on the win.
Good, thank you.
Norm Ellenberger, our postgame guest, as always. We'll be back with a final note after the 60-second timeout.
Be smart. Let 1993 bring you something free.
At Budget Car and Truck Rental, after you rent any car or van five times, you get a free day rental on an economy through full-size car. Budget provides you with a personalized frequent renter card to use every time you rent. It's good at all Budget Rent-A-Car of Central Indiana locations. So, when you need an economy car, mid-size car, full-size car, luxury car, minivan with unlimited mileage and special daily, weekly, and weekend rates, call Budget. Be smart. Start off 1993 with a guarantee of something free. Call now and reserve a new Buick Regal custom sedan with power windows and cassette, a sporty Pontiac Grand Prix, or a spacious Pontiac Transport SE minivan, and you'll be on the road to your free day rental. Whether for business or pleasure, the more you rent, the more free days you get. Budget Car and Truck Rental, located at 3305 South Street and at the Purdue Airport in Lafayette. Call today, 743-3987. That's 743-3987. Budget, where you get the best deals on wheels.
Back once again at Penn State University for the final time tonight. Indiana, double overtime winner over Penn State, 88-84 is the final. Top score for the Nittany Lions, 22 for Michael Jennings, 19 for John Amici. And for Indiana tonight, it was Calvert Cheney with 24, 18 out of Greg Graham, 16 from Alan Henderson, and 13 for Damon Bailey. But Brian Evans hit the winning shot here tonight and was the big difference in this ball game with 5 seconds to go in the second overtime. You can't say enough, Max, about the heart of this basketball team, if not the perfectionist play that we hope to see in this contest. But nevertheless, Penn State gave Indiana all they wanted here tonight as well.
Well, they certainly did, and Indiana certainly showed heart tonight because they were down and out of this thing two or three times. They could shoot only 44.7%, while the Penn State Nittany Lions were 48.4%. You talked about Henderson just a moment ago with 16 points. He had 17 rebounds tonight. He added 10 of them in the first half, picked up 7 more in the second half.
All right, Indiana now stands 21-2 on the season, 10-0 in the Big Ten. Penn State goes to 6-12 overall, 1-8 in the conference. Again, the final, 88-84 in double overtime. The Hoosiers next up against Michigan on Sunday at the Assembly Hall. Their second straight three-game road trip is out of the way, and the Hoosiers have come away unscathed in the loss column. So again, it's Michigan and Indiana coming up on Sunday. Airtime will be at 3:20 with a Bob Knight pregame show. Tip at 3:45. Until then, for Max Skirvin, this is Don Fischer. So long, everybody.